that is when you're sitting in his chair.
Hey-o. Hey-o. Hey! Hello, everybody, and welcome to Harrisonville, Missouri. I am Chad Kramer alongside Tarzan. I'm sorry. We got to laugh a little bit. We always got to laugh at ourselves. Gary was unaware that we were on the air, and I think he was getting a couple of hey-os in there as we were testing our microphones. But nevertheless, we are on the air, and it is our pregame show tonight, brought to you by our friends at Farmers Insurance, Brad Sainer Agency. If you are preparing for an insurance quote, give Brad a call today. Gary, here we are. It is fourth game of the year. It is the second home game, and it's that dreaded homecoming for every coach.
Yeah, and I talked to a coach before the game, or just a little bit ago, talking about, you know, preparation for this week, coming off last week, how well he thought they played last week. They had some, you know, some things that if they had actually played just a little bit better in some of the areas, they could have very well had a chance to win. And he thinks if they shored those up, tonight's going to be a great game and hopefully going to come away with a victory. However, like you said, tonight's homecoming with all the nice festivities and distractions that come along with it for the head coach. So the important part of it is that they can get this over with, and maybe, just maybe, then they can concentrate on the ballgame.
Yeah, and, you know, it makes it a little bit more difficult. You're coming in 0-3, you know. That being said, talked to several people from Warrensburg, obviously, this week, living over there now, and had a couple football games, and people have said, yeah, probably best 0-3 team in the state of Missouri right now. I mean, it isn't like they played a couple of slouches. They've played three state-ranked opponents, one in Class 5, two in Class 3, and they're trying to find their way. New coach, mostly new coaching staff on both sides of the ball. They lost their head coach from last year. They lost their offensive coordinator, changing things up. So that's going to be something that they've been adjusting to, but we reiterate it. People get tired of us probably saying it, but trophies are won in November, not in September. And that's why they play those games early in the year.
Absolutely. And talking with Coach Conley of Warrensburg, you know, he recognizes that. He recognizes the opponents that Harrisonville's played to make them 0-3. And therefore, he knows the MICDSs and the Pleasant Hills, you know, are teams that are ranked, and they gave a lot of competition to us in those games, and he recognizes that tonight's going to be a tough contest for them.
Absolutely, and you know, bottom line is they had their opportunities to win last week. Just a couple of things didn't go their way, a couple of penalties. Those are the things you get out of the way early on in the season so that you can get into the meat of your conference season and get ready to rock and roll. So I'm excited for tonight. Obviously, you know, I even posted a little bit ago on Facebook, and I was like, a little different feel for me now. You know, last year, Warrensburg was still new. This year now, we're kind of embedded in the community now. My wife goes to a lot of stuff. Last night, we play a flag football game. Coach Cavanaugh's son's on the other team. The UCM head football coach's daughter's on our team. The UCM head basketball coach's son is on the other team. So you got all these people. You start getting to know people. So it has a little different feel for me, but I'm excited to watch this game tonight and see how it unfolds.
Yeah, and I think the coaching staff of Harrisonville are excited about tonight as well, knowing how they played last week, and they felt like they had good practices this week, shored some things up from last week that they didn't do well or maybe some mistakes on, and so they're really excited about this week coming into Warrensburg.
Absolutely. Well, we're going to take a timeout. We're going to thank some of our great sponsors. We'll be back here in just a couple of minutes.
When you're searching for insurance, call an agent in town that can protect you. Call CPSK for auto, life, renter's boat, ATV, or any other weekend toy you want covered. CPSK Insurance is an auto owner's affiliate, so call and talk to Summer, Randy, Amanda, or Chandra. They can give you a quote and get you covered quickly and easily. Business coverage is available as well. Call them today at 816-380-3800 or visit them online at www.cpskinsurance.com and let your local agents go to work for you.
Church & Dwight is one of the world leaders in household and personal care products, and we want you to join our team in Harrisonville. You'll get the chance to work with winning brands that consumers love. We offer starting salaries ranging from $20.50 to $39 per hour, depending on experience. A signing bonus of $2,500. Comprehensive benefits, paid time off, and every other weekend is a three-day weekend. To apply, go to churchdewight.com and click on Careers.
Football season is here, and cold weather is sure to follow. Time to head to Young's Auto Repair and get your vehicle ready for winter. Flush the radiator, get an oil change, and make sure the heater is ready to keep your family rolling down the road all winter. If something else is wrong with your vehicle, bring it in and let Young's diagnose the problem to get you back on the road. Young's Auto, across the road from Young's Tire and Wheel Center on South Commercial Street.
Yes. Welcome back. They're going through homecoming festivities right now. They've got the candidates coming out on the field and stuff, and all the teams are in the locker room. And we're getting ready to rock and roll for some football on Friday night here at Harrisonville Stadium, where the Harrisonville Wildcats will be taking on the Warrensburg Tigers. Chad's away for just a second, so you're going to get a little chance to listen to me for just a minute. Really excited about the game tonight. After last week, they were 0-2 going into last week. Pleasant Hill. Pleasant Hill is a ranked team. They really played well last week. They just didn't make the best of some of the opportunities that they did have to be able to win the game. But this week, coming into this week, they had a good week of practice after talking to the coach, Maxwell, and he thought that they really prepared this week well for Warrensburg, and I think they're going to be able to come away with a win tonight. What do you think, Chad?
You know, it's going to be a toss-up game, but it is there for the taking tonight, and they just got to take care of business, which kind of lends me into our keys to the game. Sorry, I was a little bit late coming back over there talking, and 3 minutes goes really fast when you're having a conversation off to the side, Gary.
Well, for you, 3 minutes is just like a second.
Right, exactly. So, my keys to the game tonight, key number one is keep the big guys down, okay? They are bigger than Harrisonville on both lines. And a matter of fact, they have two gentlemen, Luke Fatka and Tony Farr, have already been offered by UCM's new head football coach. So you've got to dominate the line tonight, and that's going to go twofold, because if you can win the line of scrimmage battle, even if they're bigger than you, then that means Nate Reynolds and Mason are going to have a good night as well.
Well, quickness can overcome weight. You know, it depends on the quickness that these big guys up front have. But a lot of times, if you're good in technique, that quickness can overcome that weight, and you can use the quickness against them. And, you know, watching Moore and watching Reynolds run, they don't just run and hit the hole immediately. They're patient with the running, and that way they'll be able to hit the hole that opens up whichever way the block is taken.
And key number two for me is skills. You got the skills. I mean, in my opinion, seeing both of these teams on paper, Harrisonville has a little bit of an advantage on the skill position kids. So you've got to take advantage of that tonight. And it kind of lends from number one to number two. If you can control the line, like you said, they're bigger on the line. We got the skill position. Can that speed overcome the lines?
Well, and you look at the skill positions on defense, the D-backs. You know, the first couple of games, they really had some tough games. Last week, they looked pretty good. They played some good defense. They had some very good defensive of some passes. And Warrensburg's going to pass. I mean, they like to pass. And so, therefore, we're going to get tested again this evening on the D-backs, and we're going to see how well that they've come over the last several weeks.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see, which brings me to key number three is relax. Okay, yeah, you're 0-3, but if you start pressing – then you're going to start making mistakes. You cannot, if you get down, let's say you get down early, you can't press and be like, oh no, here we go again, and try doing silly things. Just relax and let the game come to you.
Well, and what better coach to have in this position right now, where you had a Maxwell state championship, a 2016 head coach. You know, he saw the team go from 3-0 to 3-3 over the next three, the six game span. But the three games they lost in a row, he was able to get them to relax and get them to come back in their own game. And they ended up in the state championship. So I'm not too worried about that in the event that trying to keep them relaxed, because I think Max is going to be able to take that.
Yeah, and if that happens, I think everything goes smoothly. You can find yourself 1-3 after tonight, 1-1 in the conference. Got a very winnable game next week against Summit Christian. And then you go back to the MRVC. It doesn't get easier with Center coming or coming to town in 2 weeks.
Oh, absolutely. And I want to welcome everybody, obviously, here, but I want to ask them to stay to our postgame show. I got to tell you how excited I was about the halftime and postgame last week. I was watching the Chiefs after the game last night, and they were going through highlights, you know, and I was thinking, hey, we were kind of like that on Friday night, you know, so it's excited. Stay along with us for the postgame because you're going to see some of the best plays of the game in postgame and halftime.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. We have got a great production team. They do a great job of making sure that we have replay and we have all of those different things. So I'm excited about it. I'm excited because it's Warrensburg Harrisonville. Means a little bit different to me this year and probably in the future being in Warrensburg now. So it's going to be fun. I'm excited about it. I know you're excited. It's homecoming. You got those festivities going on here tonight. And
thank you so much.
We're getting ready for another timeout coming your way here in just a couple of seconds to thank some of our great sponsors. We'll be back with our opposing team starting lineup in a few minutes, as well as some other stuff. We'll see you after this.
You have choices when buying a vehicle. Show Me Auto Mall is your right choice. Getting you financed with even less than perfect credit, because everyone needs a reliable vehicle at an affordable price. Need service? Take a loaner while you wait. With a broad selection, you will find a vehicle that is right for you. Show Me Auto Mall is here to make buying a vehicle hassle-free. Go see the crew at Show Me today on 291 across from Walmart.
Before every big purchase, you have to prepare. Prepare the easy way by calling Harrisonville's Farmers Insurance agent, Brad Sainer. Brad will make sure there are no holes in your coverage and take care of you with any life's mishaps. Prepare for great insurance coverage by calling Brad Sainer at 816-974-8105. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, ba-dum, bum, 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 bum.
New logo, new colors, new app, and a new online banking platform. There may be a lot of new at Sherwood Community Bank, but one thing remains the same: community. Serving the area with 4 convenient locations, Sherwood is still your community bank. Come see what it's like to be part of the community with a new account. The small town bank with big city convenience. Sherwood Community Bank, your community bank.
Sherwood Heating and Cooling provides quality services and amazing products from Carrier. Always going the extra mile to ensure that your heating and cooling units keep performing at optimal levels. Sherwood Heating and Cooling wants your family to be as comfortable as their own. Products come with warranties and service checkups by trained technicians that give you peace of mind. Call and schedule an appointment at 816-862-6610.
Hey, Harrisonville. Say hi to several friendly faces from your neighborhood Culver's, home of delicious Butterburgers and fresh frozen custard that's always cooked to order. Stop by and try our double Butterburger with cheese, made with fresh, never frozen beef, seared on the grill as you order on a lightly buttered and toasted bun. And for dessert, grab a rich and creamy fresh frozen custard made in small batches all day long. See you there. Go Wildcats.
When you need a part for your vehicle or farm equipment, it's good to have someone local. Harrisonville Auto Parts, stocked with NAPA products, is your local provider. No need to go to a national chain and pay marked up prices. Instead, keep your money and business local with Harrisonville Auto Parts. Next time the headlight goes out, head over to Harrisonville Auto Parts and have them take care of you. Next to Young's Tire and Wheel Center on Commercial.
You want the best price from the best dealership? At Max Motors, we make it easy. Purchase or order your next new vehicle at invoice pricing. We honor all AXZ and D plans, supplier pricing, and industry offers. At Max Motors, we guarantee to beat any dealer's online price by $500. Check out the Max Motors guarantee. Contact us for a hassle-free quote. Max Motors is the easiest place to buy a car with the highest trade-in values in the Midwest. MaxMotors.com. See dealer for details.
Take the struggle of making homemade pizza out of the equation. Go see Marshall and Stephanie Hamilton, the new owners of Harrisonville Papa Murphy's, and let them do the prep work. Daily specials, new calzones, fresh sides, creative fundraising, and limited time pizzas, there's something for the whole family. Don't forget, win or lose discounts every Saturday after the game on your order or $20 or more. Simply type CATS50 after a win or CATS25 after a loss and save big with Papa Murphy's of Harrisonville.
Looking for the most effective way to create clean, germ-free spaces where you live, work, and do business? Do you wish you could avoid required wet times, unpleasant odors, and residues left behind by often harsh chemicals? If you're looking for better ways to protect others from harmful infections or lost business and productivity, then call RenewRight today. We're here to provide you with the tools you need to promote safety and peace of mind that those counting on you deserve. If you want disinfection done right, then call RenewRight today at 816-226-7654.
Everyone needs an advocate in the insurance world. Let Lacey Domnick of Shelter Insurance be an advocate for you. With free policy review and quotes, she aims to help you weigh your options. With auto, home, life, and business insurance, Lacey wants you to have a positive and friendly experience. A former Wildcat herself, it is important for Lacey to support the community and Wildcats. Call today to set up an appointment at 816-380-2700 with Lacey.
All right, welcome back to Harrisonville, Missouri. It is homecoming 2022, and we're going to have high school football coming your way in about 15 minutes or so, actually 25 minutes or so. They're going to kick off at 7:15 tonight. Right now they are having the Hall of Fame inductees getting ready to hear one. A lot of people may know this kid's name getting ready to be inducted. His name is Travis Britz, and people may remember my famous call from 2011, maybe? Or
Kearney.
Oh, yeah. Quarterfinal game. Travis Britz to the house. He breaks a tackle. And Brett Jones still jokes about that. He goes, my ears are still ringing from that call. And what was really cool about that call, it was on the radio. That was back infancy before we had the video. And when I called that, our coaches were right above us. So you can hear in the background, yeah, high fives and stuff. Because nobody expected Harrisonville to be in that game. That was probably the signature win in Coach Litt's career at Harrisonville. They knocked off Kearney 14-10 that day. They had the right game plan, and it was a fun game to be a part of.
Oh, I wasn't calling games at that point in time. I was just a spectator in the stands. And I think not only think people went wild over there in your box and above you, but our stands went wild because, you know, when you saw Travis going to the backfield, you almost kind of know what's going to happen, but you really don't know. And my gosh, that was a very exciting part of Harrisonville football.
It was a fun time. This one was help getting things off the ground too. Chad Spear, who's out there as well, he's now down in southeastern Oklahoma somewhere. Starts with an M. He's head coach down there. He was also at Southeast Oklahoma for several years as a defensive coordinator. He was at Leavenworth. Ron Dunham brought him from Harrisonville to Leavenworth to be the head coach when he went up there to be the AD, and he came from there. His brother, defensive coordinator at Smithville right now, won a state title last year. So a little background on Chad, and then we talked about Travis Britz getting ready to come out as well and be inducted, which is awesome. So those are great Hall of Famers.
Yeah, and Travis, went down and talked to him just a little bit ago before they went out on the field. He is going to join us at halftime for a brief few minutes. So therefore, stay tuned at halftime. We'll be able to talk to him. He is at Okie State now, and either next week or the following week, I was asking him, when you play K-State, or is it Okie State or is it K-State? He says it's at K-State, and he said it's going to be interesting to be on the opposite side in front of the stands, which is probably the loudest over there because that's all the student section and everything else. So he said he's kind of excited about going back, and plus he knows a lot of the people.
Well, you know, tell you a lot about Travis in doing all that as well. He got a tryout with Tampa Bay out of college. He was all Big 12 multiple years. He was a great special teams player. I don't know how many extra points and field goals that he blocked in his time at K-State. He might have the record for that.
Yeah, I mean, he started it here and he continued it over there when he went to K-State. I mean, they put him in the middle and he did. I don't know how many he had. Maybe he'll remember. And when he comes up at halftime, that'll be a quiz for him to ask how many blocks he had.
Well, before we go to another break here in just a couple of minutes, I want to give a shout out now to two Warrensburg sponsors that came on board. We always like to get a visiting team or an opposing team on board. And I want to give a big shout out to B&B Glass and Power Washing and P31 Salon and Spa, who are sponsoring the starting lineups and the play of the game tonight for the Warrensburg Tigers. If you're a Warrensburg fan, you're watching, please give them a call. Kyler does a great job. Elizabeth does a great job. They would be happy to have you as a client. Offensive starters for the Tigers tonight. It'll be Kobe Westfall at quarterback. Your running backs will be Kenny Hong and Xavier Morris. The wide receivers, Cole Kreisel and Quinn Conley. On the line, it'll be Luke Fatka and Tony Farr, who both have offers standing from UCM. Maddox Cullenkamp, Lucas Graves, and Eli Anderson. And getting to know names now, Gary, of these starting lineups. Conley. Coach Connolly's son is one of the wide receivers. Xavier Morris, his nephews, or his cousins, are on Braxton's flag football team. Kendrick and Houston Morris play on Braxton's flag team and have got to be real good friends with Braxton. So you start seeing these names, start knowing these kids. It's kind of fun.
Well, and I ask you, before we went on the air, how many more years are we going to hear the word Munsterman? Because he's been a thorn in our side for years. Not him, but that family. They've always produced great athletes, and we've got another one that's starting as a linebacker Warrensburg.
Zach was the one that graduated last year. Ryan is starting as a sophomore, so real good player. So all these names, people know the Munsterman name over there. He is also the sheriff. Scott Munsterman is my cousin. So it's kind of fun, too, to call your relatives games as well. But again, another shout-out to B&B Glass and Power Washing, Kyler and Elizabeth Tucker, and P31 Salon and Spa. They will take care of you over in Warrensburg. We'll be back after this.
Ready to upgrade your patio for those football watch parties? Call Ethan Young with 2-3 Construction Services to get started today. He can create a fun patio area complete with a fire pit in case it gets a bit chilly for one of those Wildcat or Chiefs fall nights. If a new driveway or floor for the shop is part of your upgrade, he will help you there as well. Call Ethan today at 816-533-2119 and 2-3 Construction Services to work for you.
Everyone needs a little kickstart at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so head to Sonic of Harrisonville and kick away the afternoon fog. Grab an ice-cold drink full of caffeine and kickstart your afternoon and evening. The best part, 2 to 4 is happy hour, and drinks are half price. Grab an afternoon snack of Cheesy Bites or Jalapeno Poppers, or order on the app for happy hour anytime. Sonic Happy Hour, where you kick away the fog. Also, visit 4tees.com and sign up for the Sonic Kick Return Contest.
Insurance is something we all have to have. Go somewhere with all insurances in one place. Stafford & Stafford Insurance. With auto, commercial, life, health, farm, and crop insurance, Stafford has you covered. With coverage like that, they are sure to have the right policy for you. Instead of dreading a call to get an insurance quote, call the team that covers it all. Stafford & Stafford Insurance, located on Commercial across from Holland's Auto Sales.
What is one of your most precious commodities? Time. With sports, family, work, and school, time is precious. So why drive hours and waste time to save $20? Shop local and buy your home appliances at Troby's Maytag Home Appliance Center right here in Harrisonville. They deliver, service, issues that arise, all while you're putting money right back into the community. Stop wasting time and think Troby's first when you think of home appliances on Plaza Drive right behind Hawthorne Bank.
Wellness is the state or condition of ideal physical and mental health. We at the Wellness Counseling Center are passionate helpers. From the foundations of love, grace, kindness, and joy, we hope to humbly encourage others to embrace their self and find peace. Because when I is replaced by we, even illness can become wellness. Call us at 816-974-7378 and set up an appointment so we can change your I into a we.
It always seems to happen. We buy new tires and a week later we run over a nail. Not a problem when you have purchased your tires at Young's Tire and Wheel Center. You get free flat repair for the life of your tires. On a budget, Young's is the best selection of new and used tires to save a little extra money. When the time comes for new tires, stop at the shop 4T's Trust to keep them rolling down the highway. Young's Tire and Wheel Center on South Commercial in Harrisonville.
Hey, ready? Hey, grab that right there. Are you ready?
Oh.
Is you ready?
Ready.
You say you ready.
Oh.
Whole squad ready.
Ready.
Is you ready?
Huh?
Are you ready?
Ready.
Is you ready? Whole squad ready.
We came here to see Jet. What you got?
Oh.
No, no, no.
Not on my watch.
No way.
Bring what you got. I'm going to the top.
Hey.
You can bring what you got. I'm going to the top.
Just got done running a bunch of quotes.
Why would anyone want their quotes done here?
Fast quotes, accurate quotes, family owned and operated.
Well, tell me more. What do they offer?
Commercial, auto, home, life. Here, scan the QR code. I gotta get back to running.
All right.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Harrisonville, Missouri. We're about 15 minutes away or so from the opening kickoff here on a Friday night in Harrisonville, Homecoming 2022. It is your pregame show brought to you by our friends at Farmers Insurance, Brad Sainer Agency. If you're preparing for an insurance quote, give Brad a call today. Gary, all the pomp and circumstance of homecoming, and it takes another 15 minutes to get kicked off. You know how that always rolls.
Yeah, it seems like it just goes on and on for the coaching staff. And, you know, there was only two players out there, but still, you know, most athletes are kind of a habit, a form of habit, you know, things that happen. 15 minutes doesn't sound like a whole lot, but, you know, they probably arrived at the stadium the same time tonight. They went through warm-ups and everything pretty much the same because then they had to clear the field, obviously, for the festivities, homecoming and the awards. And so, therefore, once that's all over, now you've got another 16 minutes and 2 seconds before the game even starts. And so they don't like that. So we're going to kind of see. And unfortunately, it affects probably more the home team than it does the visitors team because for them, they didn't have to do anything other than just go out, do the warm-ups, go back to the locker room and talk, and then be able to come back out. So, you know, after the first play, hopefully things will get into motion for the Cats and things are good. Again, I'm hopeful that we win the toss, we defer, get the ball in the second half, and that way we can, you know, possibly at the end of the first half, you know, be able to get a touchdown and come back and get another touchdown.
Yeah, and you know, while we got extra time, you know, I say we got extra time, but I believe we're getting ready to go to the national anthem. So when we go to the national anthem, we'll cut back for a break and then we'll come back. But when we come back, I would like to talk about all our great sponsors. They're the ones that make this possible. And our sponsors, we've hit it out of the park with our sponsors this year. It's been amazing. Even on the road, some of our other towns coming together and sponsoring their teams as well. So,
you know, the great sponsors and also the great production staff we've got here. I mean, you can see what it's really done for us for this year. So
absolutely. So we're going to go ahead and take a timeout. We'll probably take a minute or two, and then we'll be back with more on your pregame show brought to you by Farmers Insurance, Brad Sainer, after this.
Church & Dwight is one of the world leaders in household and personal care products, and we want you to join our team in Harrisonville. You'll get the chance to work with winning brands that consumers love. We offer starting salaries ranging from $20.50 to $39 per hour, depending on experience. A signing bonus of $2,500, comprehensive benefits, paid time off, and every other weekend is a 3-day weekend. To apply, go to churchdwight.com and click on careers.
When you're searching for insurance, call an agent in town that can protect you. Call CPSK for auto, life, renter's boat, ATV, or any other weekend toy you want covered. CPSK Insurance is an auto owner's affiliate, so call and talk to Summer, Randy, Amanda, or Chandra. They can give you a quote and get you covered quickly and easily. Business coverage is available as well. Call them today at 816-380-3800 or visit them online at www.cpskinsurance.com and let your local agents go to work for you.
Football season is here, and cold weather is sure to follow. Time to head to Young's Auto Repair and get your vehicle ready for winter. Flush the radiator, get an oil change, and make sure the heater is ready to keep your family rolling down the road all winter. If something else is wrong with your vehicle, bring it in and let Young's diagnose the problem to get you back on the road. Young's Auto, across the road from Young's Tire and Wheel Center on South Commercial Street.
Hey, Harrisonville. Say hi to several friendly faces from your neighborhood Culver's, home of delicious Butterburgers and fresh frozen custard that's always cooked to order. Stop by and try our double Butterburger with cheese made with fresh, never frozen beef, seared on the grill as you order on a lightly buttered and toasted bun. And for dessert, grab a rich and creamy fresh frozen custard made in small batches all day long. See you there. Go Wildcats.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Harrisonville. We are still about 10 minutes or so away from your opening kick. Warrensburg yet to come back out on the field. Harrisonville about ready to take the field for the game tonight. We've had all the extra activities of homecoming, and now we're about ready to rock and roll here from Harrisonville. And when we talked about it, it's our pregame show right now, brought to you by Farmers Insurance, Brad Sainer, Agency. Next time you're preparing for an insurance quote, give Brad a call. Talk about our great sponsors, Gary. You see it up in the corner. Powered by Church & Dwight. A broadcast powered by Church & Dwight here in Harrisonville. Probably West Central Missouri's largest employer in the area. And they've been on board with us the last couple of years and glad to have them on board.
Yeah, and I remember the day that you got them. You call or text, and then we talked about it. How great it is to have such a wonderful sponsor. Plus all the other sponsors, you know, that have continued to bring Harrisonville and the other communities high school football Friday nights.
Right, and then our awesome scoreboard we've got this year, the Warren and Mounts Agency scoreboard. You've also got these guys back here doing a great job getting us a actual time on the scoreboard as well. But let's run down them. CPSK Insurance, Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center, Aiken's PC Repair, American Heritage Realtors, Colby's Car Clinic, Young's Auto Repair, Young's Tire and Wheel Center, Stafford Insurance, Sherwood Community Bank, Stoico Tree Service, Church & Dwight, Sonic, Culver's, Max Motors, Wellness Counseling Centers, Sherwood Heating and Cooling, Show Me Auto Mall, Commerce Bank, Lacey Dominic of Shelter Insurance, Schroeder's Chiropractic, Domino's Pizza, Brad Sainer, Farmers Insurance Agency, the Red Barn Ranch. Folks, it is opening weekend at the Red Barn Ranch this weekend. Go out and have some fun. Renew Right, Signature Wheel and Trust, the Scavuzzo Law Firm, Casco Area Workshop, Papa Murphy's, Harrisonville Auto Parts, Napa, 2-3 Construction Services, Warren Mounts Agency, Excalibur Contracting, and Cider House. We've got some great sponsors. And, you know, what I love about this list, Gary, we can go down on every single one and be like, oh, we trade with them. We do business with them. I say trade. I had to explain to my kids this week in class when I was talking about trading, we were talking about the economy. I said, well, I go, you probably got grandpas will tell you they go do their trading in Warrensburg. That's what they used to say when they'd go buy groceries and stuff. And the kids were like, huh? They had no concept. But when I say that, we've all done business with all these folks. And it is a week in and week out.
Yeah, we don't just promote them. You know, people that I go out and recruit are people that I do business with on a weekly, monthly basis and stuff. And so as we welcome the Cats to the field, I love this, that they're coming down the field, getting there on the 50-yard line, and they'll come on out. I haven't really seen the band do this for a while. It's kind of fun to see them do that.
What I like is the confidence coming out tonight. We talked about it in the pregame show and in the keys of the game. You know, they could press a little bit. You think maybe they'll press a little bit. They're 0-3. They got to get that first win. They want to get that first win. They're going against a 2-1 conference opponent. They don't. They seem loose, and that's good because that means that they're not nervous about getting that first win. They're just ready to take care of business, and I think last week's game had a lot to do with that.
You know, and this – you know, getting a win out of tonight really propels them into the rest of their season, into not next week, but then the rest of the conference games that they've got coming along the way. So you really want to not press. You want to go out as relaxed as you possibly can, play your kind of football, and bring home a win for the Cats tonight, and then continue business throughout the rest of their year.
Absolutely. And, you know, I told you we may have some Warrensburg folks watching tonight. Got my first Warrensburg text. Got to give a shout-out to Brady Figg, watching at home. He's on our flag football team, and his dad, Brandon Figg, one of the assistant principals over at the middle school. So, guys, thanks for watching us tonight. Hopefully we can bring you a good broadcast. We're awaiting the coin toss coming up here in just about 20 or 30 seconds as we get the captains out there on the field. And I think both teams at this point are like, can we get the ball game kicked off? Kind of like we are, Gary. I think we're ready to go play some football.
I was ready 15 minutes ago, so, you know, it is hard for when you've got extra festivities prior to the game to stay down because, I mean, you're ready to roll, ready to play some football, you just got to continue to wait. Kind of those that are following, I'm going to go give you some stats from prior games if you want. As far as Reynolds goes, because I know some of them were kind of following that, the first game he Nate Reynolds had 15 carries, 92 yards. Then the next game against Maryville, he had 24 carries for 162 yards. And then last week, he was kind of held in check for a while until he got that 50-yard run. And then he ended up with a total of 20 carries for 143 yards.
And he's building up each week. He really is. He's getting there. If you look at the two backs, you look at Jace, his older brother, you look at him, they're different runners. They really are. They're different, but they're the same. Nate's got that top end speed. I think Nate's a little bit faster. Jace is probably watching Truman State tonight going, seriously, coach? Seriously, Chad? But I think Nate's a little bit faster. However, I think Nate's a little bit more of a natural athlete, but I think Jace saw the field better. And we saw that several times throughout the years. One run before halftime, he needed 32 yards to get in the end zone on an untimed down. You can watch him just weave his way through, and he followed everywhere he needed to go to get into the end zone. That's going to come with Nate over the next 3 years. I mean, he's got 2.5 years left, so that's going to come from him. So they're different backs, but they're the same back. And many people from Warrensburg have said, Harrisonville's going to be good as long as there's a Reynolds in the backfield. And I was just mentioning Brandon Figg a little bit ago, the assistant principal. He was the middle school football coach for years. He goes, I know who Nate Reynolds is. I had to play against him. So they understand, everybody knows from both towns who's going to be the back for Harrisonville tonight.
Well, it's going to come from experience. You know, Jace got it, obviously, through the years of experience. The one thing that Nate really has that maybe Jace didn't was that older brother right before him that was playing with him. Because Nate was able to be out here and watch older brother and learn from a lot of the things that older brother did. So,
and you want to talk about a kid that people respect on his own team. Nate Reynolds is a sophomore. He's one of the team captains. He was elected a team captain by his team. That says a little bit about the type of kid he is. I'm in trouble already because one of our great sponsors, Lacey Dominick, texts me and says, somebody said your Warrensburg pride's showing through a little bit tonight. So I got a Harrisonville person on me already. And then I've also got another Warrensburg person on me, Jason Abner, who's my wife's assistant principal over at Sterling. Those two make a great team. They do a great job together. And after I gave the shout out to Brandon and Brady, he goes, hey,
what about me?
So Jason Abner, I'm glad you're watching and listening tonight. Hopefully we bring you a good broadcast as well. And we're excited to be able to bring the broadcast tonight.
And Lacey, thank you, because I wanted to, but I wasn't going to sit and stand next to him, so thank you for pointing that out to him. So we've talked about also, you can't see us right now, but we're in gray tonight up here. And if you notice throughout the game, their coaching staff is in gray. And I threatened, I told Chad that he must have contacted one of the coaching staff, said, hey, what color are you going to be tonight? We'll beat that up in the booth.
I will tell you right now, when I went over and talked to Coach Kavanaugh before the game and was sitting on the bench with him and talking, he was in a maroon shirt. I assure you, I had no idea that they were wearing gray. But, yes, they are wearing gray. That's just kind of the breaks of the game.
But we got to have fun because if you look at our sidelines, they're in gray.
Yes. So, hey, see, I knew what was happening. I had it all planned out, gray and gray. I can't go wrong because we got gray on and Warrensburg got gray. So I couldn't go wrong tonight, Gary. And
that is true.
The breaks of the game. We're getting ready to have the coin toss. Gary will give you who wins that here in just a second. Again, want to give a shout out to B&B Glass and Power Washing and P31 Salon and Spa, the Warrensburg sponsors for the Warrensburg Tigers tonight. Kyler does a great job. Elizabeth does a great job. Definitely patronize those of your Warrensburg fans watching tonight and go see them and take care of them as well. And for the Wildcats tonight out there as captains, it's Kale Weber, it is Espen Glenn, it is Mason Mitchell, and it is Nate Reynolds. For Warrensburg, big guys in the middle, Luke Vatka and Tony Farr, along with Kenny Hong. And I believe that might be Xavier Morris, but I'm not 100% sure on the near side here. It is Xavier Morris. So those are the four captains for both sides as we are ready to roll here from Harrisonville. As soon as we get that coin toss, we will send it to a quick break before we have tonight's opening kickoff. I want to thank you for joining us tonight for our extended pregame show brought to you by our friend Brad Sainer at Farmers Insurance. Next time you're preparing for an insurance quote, give Brad a call today. Brad Sainer told me he was going to be here today. So I'm not sure. I haven't seen Brad Sainer, but I told him to come up and see us, so we'll see if Brad graces us with his presence tonight. Gary, what do you got?
It looked like Warrensburg won the toss. He didn't show that. Normally he does. But it looked like Warrensburg won the toss. It looked like they deferred. But anyway, our Cats are going to be receiving the ball, starting off coming from the south end zone, going north, and Warrensburg will be going south.
And actually, I think we'll just keep it here with you since we're getting ready for the kickoff and get ready to rock and roll. So we're ready for high school football. Warrensburg going to be in their away. White tops, white bottoms, maroon numbers, maroon letters, maroon helmet. Cats in their gray tops, gray bottoms, blue numbers with the white outline, blue helmets. I like what they've done this year. Anybody knows college football, they know Ohio State. They got the Buckeye stickers. You do something good, you get a sticker. Get a Buckeye. There's an old ESPN commercial years ago. Here's a Buckeye. Here's a Buckeye. And they kept sticking it all over the newsroom. I'm not sure what's on the Cats helmet. I may let you look at that and find out what it is. But they have something similar on the back. There's no logo on the actual helmet. It's just those stickers.
It's a cat paw.
And there you go. They got cat paws on the back. So I like it. So they're in their gray tops, gray bottoms, blue numbers, blue out or white outline, blue helmets with the cat paws on the back that are for special things they've done during the game. It is Inge back to receive it along with, I believe that's Eli Baker. So Inge and Baker back to receive it for the Cats. Set to kick off is Rylan Henry. He's the kicker and the punter. He's an ambidextrous punter. He can rugby left and rugby right. That is something to watch here tonight as well. High end over end kick taken by Inge at his own 5-yard line. Puts it on the turf, picks it up at the 10, 15, 20, 25, 20 to the outside, 25, 30 down the sideline, out of bounds at the 43-yard line. Probably a good time to tell you about our Sonic kick return contestant tonight, Renee Mayer. You are a Sonic kick return contestant. If the Wildcats return a kick for a touchdown, it'll be a $90 Sonic gift card. If they don't, you will still receive a $10 Sonic gift card. as well. So that is our first giveaway tonight. We'll be giving away some Papa Murphy's pizza in a little bit, and we will be giving away a 4T's tumbler. If you want to sign up, go online to 4T's.com. There is a sign-up button for our giveaways. You can sign up for that here tonight.
It's about a 36-yard kickoff return by Inge.
So here we go. Shotgun formation for the Cats. Mitchell in the backfield, along with Reynolds. And Reynolds is going to get the first handoff. He's past the 40 up to about the 45, drugged down by a host of Tigers, including number two, Ryan Munsterman. How many times do you think I'm going to call him Zach tonight?
Well,
and he's going to be mad. And Zach will be laughing. Zach will be like, see, I told you I left a legacy there. I asked Zach about it. I said, how do you like Ryan having your number? He goes, well, I'm glad he has it. Nobody else. So.
Well, and you're probably by your senior year, three more years, you'll probably have it down.
Yeah, exactly. Two wide receivers set far side. Lone back in the backfield is Moore, but Reynolds going to join him back there on second and six. Fake the handoff. Mitchell looks to throw. He throws it out in the flats. Has his man first down. Cats past midfield into the 48-yard line. Caught by Slade Holden on the catch.
That's the first down.
So that is a Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center first down. Think Trobe's first when you think home appliances.
You got to like what they did there. You know, I think Warrensburg is probably going to be playing the run because we got two good runners. Fake the run up the middle, and it was able to pull the linebackers up, which left Holden open.
So here we go, first and 10, ball to 48. Here we go on first down for the Cats. And they're going to hand off four more, and he's going to be stacked up by that massive front of Warrensburg and going to bring up a second down. Looks like he might have got about a yard out of that. Dragging all the Tigers off the bottom of the pile. Looks like the one off the bottom was Jake Sartwell. He was the first contact there. So second down and 9 coming up for the Cats. Just underway from Harrisonville. 10 to go here in the first quarter of play. Little bit late start with homecoming festivities before the game. I like they do it then though, Gary, and not at halftime.
Oh yeah.
So three wide receivers set to your far side, one to the near side. Lone back in the backfield is Reynolds. Joining him will be in motion Moore. And they're going to go up the middle with it. And Reynolds is going to have two and then is shoved back. McCracken in there. And Fatka as well. It's going to be third down and about 8. So they're going to give him a yard on that. Looked like they were initially going to mark him about the 45, mark him at the 46. So third down and 8 coming up.
You got to believe that if they get at least 4 or 5 yards here, they might consider going 4-down territory here because they're already in Warrensburg territory. So
they're going to go with 3 wide receivers near side, including Reynolds. He may be in motion. And they are going to move into motion from left to right. And then they fake the handoff, and Mitchell finds a seam, and he's got enough for a Wildcat first down, 10-yard run. And that's another Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center first down. Think Trobe's first when you think home appliances. Gary?
Great read.
Exactly what I was going to say. Great read by Mitchell. He saw the way the defense was playing, and he just took it right around the end and got an easy 10 on that one.
Well, what he tried to do on the mesh while ago when Moore was going up the middle and only gained 1, he tried to pull it. You got to believe that's – they probably talked about this, that, hey, if it's bunched up, I'm going to pull it. So be thinking that.
So go shotgun formation this time. Reynolds in the backfield next to Mitchell. Going to go in motion with Baker from left to right back out to the right side. Pitch back to Reynolds. Reynolds tries to cut to the outside, breaks a tackle, and stays on his feet inside the 35, down to about the 33-yard line. 3-yard run by Reynolds. Brings up second down.
He just showed his speed there because actually the guy had the corner, but he was able to get around him. That was one of those that he couldn't really cut it back up. He had to try to get around him.
And I felt like he had that extra gear right there. he was like, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna get around this kid and get at least a couple yards here. So brings up a second down and 7. And you got to feel they're in 4-down territory now. So a lot of things they can do on second down here. See if they go with a pass. They're gonna go in motion with Moore, put him in the backfield as well. And here we go, second down and 7. Now Mitchell looks over to the side. Wide receiver to his left, wide receiver to his right. Moore and Reynolds in the backfield. And they're going to hand off for Moore, and he barrels forward inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe 28-yard line. Sartwell in there, look like Becca as well with a little bit of penetration. Brings up third down and three. 8 minutes to go here in the opening quarter. No score. Harrisonville got the ball first after Warrensburg deferred, and they are driving. Warrensburg in their white tops, white bottoms. Harrisonville, gray tops, gray bottoms. Blue helmets for the Cats. Maroon helmets for the Tigers. Here we go on third down and three. And here's the counter to Reynolds. Stiff arm inside the 30 to the 25 yard line.
Knocked down. I don't know if they're, what they're going to do. I know Reynolds, it looked like he got a face mask, but I don't, if he didn't hold on to it, I'm not sure exactly what the flag is for. But
yeah, Reynolds stuck his arm out there for the stiff arm, maybe got a little bit too much of the face mask. We'll see.
Yeah, it's just,
oh, they're going to call it on Warrensburg. So Warrensburg got a little bit of the face mask there. I didn't quite see that. Don't know if we got a replay to pull up on that or not. So it'll be a first down for the Cats. And that's the Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center first down. Trobe's, I think Trobe's first ball down to the 20 now.
Right here is where Harrisonville needs to make a statement. They're right at the red zone. They need to go and punch it in and get seven. And they've made a statement. And they need to do that at home first series.
Yeah, get the crowd involved early. Shotgun formation this time. They have a lot of motion out of the Wildcats here early on. No motion this time. It'll be a handoff. No, it'll be a keeper by Mitchell. Thought he liked that read. Got about a yard out of it. Warrensburg was ready for it that time. Brings up second down and nine. Here, Munsterman, that name. We've talked about Ryan a little bit here. One of the ones in on the stop. Second down and nine coming up. Ball on the 19 of Warrensburg. And this is one of those drives, too, Gary. If you're the Wildcats, you don't want to stall out here. You want to punch it in. Go with that split back formation in the backfield, wide receiver each way. On second down, they're going to go counter. Nope, they're going to fake the counter and look for a pass. Got him open in the flats. Four more inside the five. Out of bounds at about the 1 yard line. Maybe they make it to two. So first and goal for the Cats on the big gainer there.
17 yard first down.
And that was only the second pass of the first drive, right?
Yep, he's two for two. Seven to Holden and 17 to Moore.
Just saw the instant replay there. Brings up first and goal down to the two. Man, James is on it. He had that dialed up before I even realized it was going. First and goal from the two split backs. I hope they give it to Moore and let him try to punch one in here. Wide receiver flanked out. They're going to go in motion with Baker, and he stays out that side. They're going to hand off up the middle to Reynolds. So Reynolds gets 1 3/4, not quite the full two he needs. Brings up second down and goal for the Cats inside the 1 yard line. So 6:05 to go. Cats have drained half a quarter here on this opening drive with a nice mix, mostly runs, Gary, but a good mix of passes when they needed it. So here we go on second down and goal. Mitchell, two backs in the backfield. They're going to go right at the middle. And a touchdown, Reynolds. So Nate Reynolds with the touchdown run. 5:43 to go here in the first quarter. Cats on top, 6-0. Here's a replay on that one, and look how quick he hits that hole. He had that handoff and was in before the linemen were off of that one, Gary.
Yeah, and that shows his quickness.
So extra point coming up.
Okay, so this is Kochmeyer. He finally got it. They finally got his jersey in. From Germany.
Kick is up and away. We'll take a timeout. Cats lead 7-0.
Before every big purchase, you have to prepare. Prepare the easy way by calling Harrisonville's Farmers Insurance agent, Brad Sainer. Brad will make sure there are no holes in your coverage and take care of you with any life's mishaps. Prepare for great insurance coverage by calling Brad Sainer at 816-974-8105. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, ba-dum, bum, 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 bum.
When you need a part for your vehicle or farm equipment, it's good to have someone local. Harrisonville Auto Parts, stocked with NAPA products, is your local provider. No need to go to a national chain and pay marked up prices. Instead, keep your money and business local with Harrisonville Auto Parts. Next time the headlight goes out, head over to Harrisonville Auto Parts and have them take care of you. Next to Young's Tire and Wheel Center on Commercial.
Welcome back. 5:43 to go. First quarter kickoff coming. We will get the scoring summary right after this kickoff by Cockmeyer. Little high end over end kick, taking it about the 10 by the Tigers. And up the middle through the hole they go. And on his feet up past the 45 is Cole Kreisel with the return. No, that was Morris, sorry. Xavier Morris. I thought that was Morris, but I couldn't tell the difference between that 6 and 8 out there. I need to get glasses, I think, Gary. So great return.
Yeah, both teams had great returns on their first kickoff return. That scoring drive by Harrisonville took 6 minutes and 15 seconds off the clock with a 1-yard touchdown run by Reynolds. It was 59 yards, 6 minutes, 15 seconds.
And that scoring drive brought to you by Lacey Dominick of Shelter Insurance. Next time you need a summary of your insurance coverages, call Lacey and she will get you taken care of. And it's always good every few years, Gary, to get you a summary of your insurance. See if you need to make changes, whether it be your home, life, auto, whatever it might be.
Yeah, absolutely. And that drive was 12 plays. And as I said, 6 minutes and over half the first quarter was taken by the Cats. So you got to love, not only took time, they had a good drive, came out with 7 points.
And Warrensburg going to line it up in a 4 wide receiver set. Westfall over on the sidelines having a conversation with the coaches and the officials. I'm not sure what's going on over there as we await. Lone back in the backfield looks like it's going to be Kenny Hong to start things off. So here comes Westfall. First and 10 from their own 45. Good field position for the Tigers on their opening drive of the ball game.
Westfall's a sophomore, so they're going to have a good two more years out of him.
So Westfall and the handoff to Hong, and he's going to barrel forward, going to get 5, maybe 6. And it'll be a 6-yard gain by Hong on first down, bring up second down and 4. And Gary, you know, the Cats struggled against the run last week. So maybe Coach Cavanaugh saw that on film and they're going to pound it at him. 2 wide receivers both ways. Shotgun for Westfall here. Hong next to him in the backfield on his right-hand side. Here we go on second down and 4 for the Tigers in Cat territory at the Cat 49. And he's looking to throw. He throws it out in the flat. Has his man for a first down. Kreisel, he's going to have it up to the 44-yard line of the Cats. So going downhill into Cat territory down after that first down. It's first and 10 down at the 44 of the Wildcats here. Coach Cavanaugh likes to mix it about 50-50, maybe go 60-40 either way, but likes to have a balanced attack. Here we go. 4 wide receiver set again, and right up the middle, Hong, and he is going to take it to the 20 and tripped up from behind from about the 15-yard line. That was Espen Glenn on the stop there, and that was a big gaping hole there.
27-yard run and first down.
So Kenny Hong with 27 yards and a first down. Going to bring it first and down to the 17-yard line with 4:15 to go here first quarter. Same formation for the Tigers, Westfall and Hong. And Hong this time nowhere to go. Good penetration by the Cats. Cale Weber in there to knock him down behind the line of scrimmage. A tackle for a loss by Weber.
That was a good shoot the gap by Weber to be able to get in the backfield and be able to stop it before it got to the line. And
that's what you're going to do if you're the Wildcats. You want to get him in second, third, and long. Force him into passing situations. Maybe get some pressure on the sophomore Westfall, see if he makes a mistake. in motion. They're going to go with Morris. They're going to fake the handoff to Morris. They're going to go in the flats again. Another completion to Kreisel. He's inside the 10 to the 9, and it'll bring up a third down in the yard coming up for the Tigers. Third and about maybe two here. 7-0 our score. First quarter of this one. Cats with a 6-plus minute, 12-play drive to get things started. And Warrensburg answering back with a quick drive of their own inside the Cat 10-yard line. Here we go on third down. And this time they're going to hand off to Hong. He's going to have the first down, and they're going to have a new set of downs inside the 7 to the 6 with 2:58 to go here in the first quarter. So it is first down, goal to go for the Tigers. Under 3 to go here, first quarter. Fast moving. We may catch up with the other game, Gary, as quick as this first quarter is moving. Going to go with a little bit different look here. Three wide receiver set. Now they're going to go in motion with Morris from right to left. They're going to hand off to Morris. No fake. The handoff. End zone. Touchdown, Kreisel. 7-6 now with 2:36 to go in the opening stanza. So Warrensburg answers quickly. Down the field in a little over 3 minutes. Watch this pass here from Westfall. The fake handoff, and then he darts it into the end zone. Gary made a comment earlier about they got a quarterback for the next 3 years, including this year in the sophomore Westfall. Kick is up and good, and we're tied at 7. We'll talk about that when we come back. We'll be back after this.
You want the best price from the best dealership? At Max Motors, we make it easy. Purchase or order your next new vehicle at invoice pricing. We honor all AXZ and D plans, supplier pricing, and industry offers. At Max Motors, we guarantee to beat any dealer's online price by $500. Check out the Max Motors guarantee. Contact us for a hassle-free quote. Max Motors is the easiest place to buy a car with the highest trade-in values in the Midwest. MaxMotors.com. See dealer for details.
Take the struggle of making homemade pizza out of the equation. Go see Marshall and Stephanie Hamilton, the new owners of Harrisonville Papa Murphy's, and let them do the prep work. Daily specials, new calzones, fresh.
All right, welcome back. 2:36 to go here in the first quarter, and we'll have Gary give us a drive summary after this kick. To wait that kickoff here from Ryland Henry. Lawful and Inge back for the Cats. Her name Mayer is our kick return contestant. Here's a high end over end kick taken at the 1 by the Cats. Up the middle they go to the 15-20 and chucked down by Ryan Munsterman up at the 24-yard line, and that's where the Cats will take over on their second drive of the night.
That Warrensburg drive was a 7-play, 55-yard drive. Took 3 minutes and 15 seconds off the clock, culminated by a 6-yard touchdown reception by Kreisel, making the score 7-7, Warrensburg and Harrisonville.
So 2:31 to go here in the first quarter. And that scoring summary brought to you by Lacey Dominic of Shelter Insurance. Next time you need a summary of your insurance, give Lacey a call and go over those today. Cats going to empty their backfield except for Reynolds. Two wide receivers each way. In motion, they're going to go with Baker. He wraps himself around and now throw it to him in the backfield. And he's going to pass. He's got his man deep. Down the sideline to the 40. To the house!
It's Eli Baker.
Answer back. Eli Baker end zone.
That 77 yards.
Drew Droege, I believe, on the reception. So Drew Droege, 70 plus yards, 78, I believe, on the touchdown from Eli Baker.
Pretty sure it was Holden.
We'll get a replay on that one. Here we go. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was Drew Drogi, number one. Kick is up. Kick is good. And we will take a timeout, and we'll be back after this.
Looking for the most effective way to create clean, germ-free spaces where you live, work, and do business? Do you wish you could avoid required wet times, unpleasant odors, and residues left behind by often harsh chemicals? If you're looking for better ways to protect others from harmful infections or lost business and productivity, then call RenewRight today. We're here to provide you with the tools you need to promote safety and peace of mind that those counting on you deserve. If you want disinfection done right, then call RenewRight today at 816-226-7654.
Everyone needs an advocate in the insurance world. Let Lacey Domnick of Shelter Insurance be an advocate for you. With free policy review and quotes, she aims to help you weigh your options. With auto, home, life, and business insurance, Lacey wants you to have a positive and friendly experience. A former Wildcat herself, it is important for Lacey to support the community and Wildcats. Call today to set up an appointment at 816-380-2700 with Lacey.
Cockmeyer set to kick it deep. Cats answer quickly. High end over end kick going to be taken by Morris at his own 5 to the 20. He's got a seam to the 30. Sideline out of bounds on the near sideline. Driven out of bounds. That was the freshman for the Wildcats. Tyson Wyatt Smith drags him out of bounds.
That last scoring drive. One play, 77-yard touchdown reception by Drogi. Extra point good, making the score 14-7, Wildcats over Warrensburg.
That scoring drive in summary brought to you by Shelter Insurance, Lacey Domnick. If you need a summary of your insurance, give her a call today. So, and that pass was from Eli Baker on the bubble screen from the wide receiver. First and 10 now, Warrensburg from their own 45. They're going to go in motion with Morris, who had the good kick return. Two good kick returns here in this one. They're going to chuck it deep. They're going to try to answer. Incomplete, but the flag on Inge. Inge and Jones battling all the way down. So that was, sorry, Ty Carman. Two number fives on their team. So Ty Carman, and they're going to call a 15-yard pass interference penalty. We'll push it into Cat territory, down to Cat 40-yard line. So 41 is where they'll officially mark it with 2:03 to go here, first quarter. 14-7, Cats in front. Warrensburg all the way back in Cat territory here in the late stages of the quarter. They're going to go in motion again with Morris. This time they fake the handoff and rolling out is Westfall. He's going to chuck it deep. He's got a man incomplete on the far side, and another penalty going to be called on the Cats. I think he got the shoulder just a little bit on that, Gary, and got him spun around.
Sometimes in high school football, though, a pass interference penalty is better than not, because especially if he catches and is able to take it into the touchdown, it's only 15 yards if it's not a spot foul.
And that's going to push it inside the 30 down to the 26. And, Gary, here's the thing. We talked about it maybe a little bit in the pregame show. You got a sophomore quarterback. Get some pressure on him. Get him happy feet. Roe had happy feet as a senior last week. We were able to get some pressure on him. Early on, he's just sitting back throwing darts. So here we go, in motion they go with Kreisel. They're going to fake the pitch back, go near side, and on his horse to the house is Morris. Xavier Morris for 6 from 26 yards out. And just like that, it's 14-13 with a minute 48 to go. So 6.5 minutes to score a touchdown. In the last 4 minutes, we've had 3 touchdowns. And it's 14-13, extra point coming up from Henry. The snap, the hold, the kick. It is good. 14-14. We'll be back after this.
New logo, new colors, new app, and a new online banking platform. There may be a lot of new at Sherwood Community Bank, but one thing remains the same: community. Serving the area with four convenient locations, Sherwood is still your community bank. Come see what it's like to be part of the community with a new account. The small town bank with big city convenience. Sherwood Community Bank, your community bank.
Sherwood Heating and Cooling provides quality services and amazing products from Carrier. Always going the extra mile to ensure that your heating and cooling units keep performing at optimal levels. Sherwood Heating and Cooling wants your family to be as comfortable as their own. Products come with warranties and service checkups by trained technicians that give you peace of mind. Call and schedule an appointment at 816-862-6610.
1:48 to go, first quarter. Gary, another scoring summary?
Yeah, one play, actually the two penalties, which aren't counted necessarily plays. One play, 26-yard touchdown run by Morris with the extra point good. Took 30 seconds off the clock. In the last 45 seconds, there's been two touchdowns, one by each team, knotted up here at 14.
So we await the Henry kick. Baker and Inge back to receive it for the Cats. Still first quarter action. And Inge going to let it bounce. And that was not the bounce he needed to let it do at the 5. And he's going to be taken down at the 10-yard line. Smart idea. I think he thought it was going to skip in the end zone, but it checked up. And Henry is a very good kicker and punter. He knows what he was doing right there. So you're gonna want to catch those on the fly. It'll be first down and 10 for the Cats from their own 10 here. So backed up deep in their own territory. You know, I opened my mouth, Gary, just a little bit ago, and I said, man, we're going to catch up with the other games. And here we are, still for first quarter, 20 minutes later after three scores. Two wide receivers set far side, split backs in the backfield. Oh, we're going to go shotgun here, sorry. In motion, fake the handoff, going to give to Moore, and Moore is going to get through contact and get about four. Second down and 6 with 1:30 to go here in the first quarter. Cats checking guys in, checking out. Nils Kochmeyer checking into the ball game. So second down and 6 coming up.
I believe you caught a pass last week, if I recall.
Absolutely. They say he really likes American football, so like to see him out there, not just as a kicker. Going to go in motion, fake the handoff, throw it out in the flats for Reynolds. Reynolds to the sideline, past the 20 and out of bounds. It'll be enough for Cat first down on the 7-yard reception from Mitchell to Reynolds with 55 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Clock stops as he runs out of bounds.
This is a first down. That's their fifth of the game.
Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center first down. Think Trobe's first when you think home appliances. Starting to get that gloss on the field. Need to churn that grass up with that machine they got. Here we go. Two backs in the backfield in motion with Baker. Stays to the outside. They hand off right up the middle Reynolds. And Reynolds first down. And about three more up to the 34-yard line. And that is the Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center first down. Just watch him squirt through quickly. And he gets a first down. Umpire back there gets out of his way. Ball judge, I should say. It's like, I need to move. He's going really fast.
That just shows you how quick he hits that hole. And if he can hit the hole quick on their defense, their front four, if he hits the right hole, he's passed in the second level.
So back-to-back plays and first downs with 25 seconds to go here, first quarter. Split back to the backfield in motion with Baker. He's going to go all the way through this time and spin back around in the backside. Fake the handoff. Pull by Mitchell. Past the 40 to about the 41-yard line. 7-yard run. Brings up second down and 3. And that is going to do it for the first quarter. So a long drive to start the first quarter. Then a track meet broke out, Gary, with 3 more touchdowns. And we're knotted at 14 after 1. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this.
You have choices when buying a vehicle. Show Me Auto Mall is your right choice. Getting you financed with even less than perfect credit, because everyone needs a reliable vehicle at an affordable price. Need service? Take a loaner while you wait. With a broad selection, you will find a vehicle that is right for you. Show Me Auto Mall is here to make buying a vehicle hassle-free. Go see the crew at Show Me today on 291 across from Walmart.
Everyone needs a little kickstart at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so head to Sonic of Harrisonville and kick away the afternoon fog. Grab an ice-cold drink full of caffeine and kickstart your afternoon and evening. The best part, 2 to 4 is happy hour, and drinks are half price. Grab an afternoon snack of Cheesy Bites or Jalapeno Poppers, or order on the app for happy hour anytime. Sonic Happy Hour, where you kick away the fog. Also, visit 4tees.com and sign up for the Sonic Kick Return Contest.
Cats on the drive here in the second quarter as we get things started. Gary, 14-14 Cats have a second and three from their own 41.
Yeah, and Warrensburg has several players that are going both ways. Now, it's a little bit cooler night tonight, but still, that attrition, you're going to see what it's going to be like in the fourth quarter, especially some of those linemen and linebackers that play both ways. You know, if we can get, you know, two or three long drives that end with touchdowns, that's going to make it very difficult on them come the fourth quarter.
Three wide receiver set to the far side, going to go in motion this time with Reynolds. He's going to come and set up in the backfield, fake the handoff to Moore, looking to throw. He's going to fake the throw out in the flats, nowhere to go. Drag him down at the 30. Right idea.
That was the right choice, because if he'd have thrown it to Reynolds, it would probably been a pick six.
So, Ballinger and Hung on the tackle on the sack. Brings up third down and almost 12 now for the Cats on their own 32-yard line. Trying to get you some scores of note in the conference here. Kearney up on Excelsior Springs 21-6 in a Class 4 matchup. There's a whistle and a timeout called by the Cats. And since we just had a break, we'll keep it right here with you on this one. 11:09 to go here in the first half of play. The Cats lead it. Center playing Christ Prep Academy. No score there. Trying to give you some more. Lafayette County and Summit Christian knotted at zero. That's Cats' opponent next week. Maryville and Pius knotted at zero. Northeast and Knob Noster. Oak Grove, Odessa. Odessa up 21-14 on Oak Grove. Mid-second quarter of that one. Scroll down. West Platte up on Plattsburgh 32-0. Pleasant Hill up 23-7 on Clinton in the second quarter. Smithville up 13-0 on Ruskin. No score from the William Chrisman St. Joe Central game. I'll be excited to hear a score from that one if we get one. So third down and 12 coming up. Cats wanted to talk it over here, as you don't want to flip-flop. Warrensburg deferred. You start kind of playing those numbers games there, Gary, thinking if you get a stop and a score, then you're on top and you can get a 2-for-1 at the half. So 11:09 to go. First half, third and 12 coming up. Shotgun formation for the Cats. Going to go in motion with Reynolds. Fake the handoff, fake the other one. Now screen. They throw the screen. Reynolds tries to get to the outside. Breaks the tackle, stays on his feet. To the 50, 40, and lowers his shoulder to the 35-yard line. Put some paint on that one, and a giant run right there.
33 yards.
Look at this replay, and look at him at the back of this. Looked like Shackelford or Othick was in his way and wasn't in his way for long as he moved him out of the way there. So Othick on the stop there. He may feel that one in the morning. First and 10 down to the 35. Another Nate Reynolds play for the Cats deep in their own territory to get out of a third and long. And right up the middle they go. Well, that almost looked like a broken play there, Gary. Almost like he was going to kneel it down, and then he pushed it forward for a couple. Brings up second and 8. And again, Gary, this is the first time this year I felt like I've seen Nate use that second gear that he's got. He did it on that outside pitch, and he did it on that screen right there.
Yeah, and if he's got the capability of doing it, he needs to use it at the right time, obviously, and that was one of them that he needed. And a lot of times, whenever he does have those big runs, that excites the offense.
So here we go. Split backs in the backfield on second and eight. And they go right up the middle with Moore, and Moore barrels forward for about eight and a first down, or to be real close to a first down.
It is a first down. That's their eighth first down of the game.
That's a Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center first down. Think Trobe's first when you think home appliances. Down to the 25-yard line. Both teams throwing haymakers early on here. They both had one play drives. Cats now sustaining another drive here. Two wide receivers to your right, one to your left. Shotgun formation in the backfield. And they're going to hand off to Reynolds. That stiff arm, nowhere to go, but he does somehow get out of it. Gets around the end and out of bounds down to about the 20-yard line. And, you know, I didn't talk about it on that first, that long run on the screen there, Gary, but he showed his strength. He stripped that first tackle, and then there again he shows his strength, stripping a tackle and making a four-yard gain out of what looked like was going to be about a three-yard loss.
Well, and he had the on that one, he had the capability of almost backing up and getting out of the tackle to get around because they had already converged. I mean, there was four or five Tigers there trying to make the tackle, and he was able to back out of it and get around on the outside.
Brings up second down and six. Trips out to the near side. They're going to go in motion with Baker from right to left, and he's going to stay out to the right side. They had a man open. Now rolling out is Mitchell. Still rolling, being chased. Now he's going to cut it down the field outside to the 15 and out of bounds. Enough for another Wildcat first down to the 14. Gary, remember we talked about that a couple of weeks ago. We said we'd like to see him when he rolls out if he doesn't see somebody to pull it upfield when he can and run it, and he does it right there.
Yes, he did. He made a good choice. After he didn't see their opening, there was nobody else open. He cut, tucked it, and ran. You like to see that on Mitchell.
So that's great play on that one by Mitchell.
And ninth first down.
Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center first down. Think Trobe's first. We think home appliances. Here we go. Ball inside the 15. They're going to go in motion this time for Reynolds up the middle. They go for Moore and Moore inside the 10 to about the 9. 5 yard gain brings up second down for the Cats with 8:57 to go here in this first half of play. The whistle and a timeout on the field.
Another 11 play drive where they stand right now. 11 play. They started at their own 10-yard line. They're now inside the 10 of the Tigers. 11 plays. And now this one has taken up 4.5 minutes. Already, and the first one took up six minutes and 15 seconds.
Not real sure what they got going here on the sidelines.
I was wondering if it wasn't one of those timeouts for the water break, but
they're saying it's an injury timeout, so maybe somebody got helped over to the sidelines. Didn't see that, but now back at it here on second down and 5 for the Cats. 8:56 to go, first half. Cats on the move again in the Warrensburg red zone at the Warrensburg 9. Two wide receivers, far side, split backs in the backfield. Second down and 6. And they're going to hand off for Moore, and Moore is going to be dead to rights at the 10, maybe loses half a yard. Going to bring up third down and 6 here. Be interested. You know, we always say they're probably in four down territory, but you might wonder, they let Cockmeyer kick one here.
He's shown me that he has a capability, and there's going to be times when they're going to need him later on in the season. And you know, what better time to do it is in a game setting. You can do it in practice all the time, but it's not the same when you get into a game.
So third down and 6 coming up. Speaking of Cockmeyer, he's out flanked to the left side. Two wide receivers to your right. Lone back in the backfield is Moore on third down, looking to throw. Nowhere to go. Taken down for a loss right through there, Tony Farr. And gets a loss. They're going to mark him all the way back at the 15-yard line, so that brings up a fourth down. Now you're at the 15. 23. You're looking at a 33-yard field goal. You got to feel maybe the Cats.
We got holding on top of it. So will they take the play or will they take? They'll probably take the play and decline the penalty.
I mean, it'll be a fourth down. It'll be a third down if you don't. You give them two shots. You got to feel like that is definite four-down territory. So I think Coach Kavanaugh is going to let it run down. No, he's talking about it over on the sideline. I thought he might let the play clock run down and call a timeout.
Penalty flag thrown. The 14-yard line. And there's the call. And he gets the catch.
So
he
declines it. Going to bring up fourth down here. Ball at the 16-yard line. So fourth and 12 from about the 16. And they are going to try the kick here. They're going to mark it at the 23. Cockmeyer from the far hash. Here we go. Snap. The hold. The kick. It is up. It is just wide to the right side. And it'll be no good. So Warrensburg will take over, and I believe at the high school level, they take over at the 20. They won't take over at where it was kicked from. And they're going to mark it at the 20. So 14-14, not what you want if you're the catch. You have a good drive going, 10-plus plays, Gary, and then it putters out down inside the 20 of your opponent, and you get 0 points.
Yeah, that was 14 play drive that ended in no points.
Two wide receivers to your left, two to your right, shotgun for Westfall. He's going to go in motion with Morris from his left to his right. They're going to fake the handoff, and Westfall going to look to throw. He's going to chuck one over the middle. He's got his man past 35 and taken down to about the 37-yard line. Cole Kreisel, that has been his go-to guy here in the ball game so far on the passes. Kreisel with a big gain up to the 36-yard line. 16-yard gain on the pass and catch by the Tigers. Now they're on the move. Trips to the left. Wide receiver all alone on the right side. Shotgun formation in motion again with Morris. And this time they're going to hand off to Morris. He gets through the first line and is taken down quickly. Jack Zan Nicholas, it looked like, in on that one. Maybe Owen Adair. We got a cat down on the field here. So we got an injury timeout. We'll take a timeout as well. 6:41 to go first half. We're all knotted up at 14.
Insurance is something we all have to have. Go somewhere with all insurances in one place. Stafford & Stafford Insurance. With auto, commercial, life, health, farm, and crop insurance, Stafford has you covered. With coverage like that, they are sure to have the right policy for you. Instead of dreading a call to get an insurance quote, call the team that covers it all. Stafford & Stafford Insurance, located on Commercial across from Holland's Auto Sales.
It always seems to happen. We buy new tires and a week later we run over a nail. Not a problem when you have purchased your tires at Young's Tire and Wheel Center. You get free flat repair for the life of your tires. On a budget, Young's has the best selection of new and used tires to save a little extra money. When the time comes for new tires, stop at the shop 4T's Trust to keep them rolling down the highway. Young's Tire and Wheel Center on South Commercial in Harrisonville.
6:41 to go here, first half of play. I think we went from an injury timeout to an actual timeout there, and both teams on the sidelines. I'm getting hungry, Gary. It's been, a couple hours since we ate. It's already 8 o'clock. I think it's time to give away some Papa Murphy's pizza. And our winner of some Papa Murphy's pizza tonight is Yvonne Beasley. Congratulations. Get a hold of Jerry, and he will get you that $25 Papa Murphy's gift card. So we are back to action. Second and 8 coming up. Ball at their own 38-yard line. For the Tigers, two wide receivers to your left, two to your right. Shotgun formation. Westfall in the backfield has his running back Hong next to him. And now on second down, he's going to throw it in the flats. Has his man past 50 to the 40, all the way into Cat territory. And Kreisel again, he has been a thorn in the Cat side tonight. Watch the replay here. Just sets in the flats in that zone. Like, and takes it. Look, a little bit of Travis Kelce-ish there. Just went and found a hole, set in it, grabbed it, and took off, Gary. And it's going to be a personal foul face mask on top of it from the 36. Going to take it down to the 21. So a big gain becomes a huge gain all the way down to the 21. Ball at 20, mark it at the 22, it looks like. Shotgun formation. In motion, they're going to go with Morris from left to right. He's going to hang out in the backfield. Now they're going to look to the sideline, talk it over. And Morris going to jog back out to his position with 5 seconds on the play clock. Now they're going to move him in motion again. And a whistle and a timeout called. Coach Cavanaugh did not like the looks of that one from the get-go as he ran him back out there, get close to a penalty, and they call a timeout. We'll take a timeout as well. Tied up, 6:07 to go, first half.
What is one of your most precious commodities? Time. With sports, family, work, and school, time is precious. So why drive hours and waste time to save $20? Shop local and buy your home appliances at Troby's Maytag Home Appliance Center right here in Harrisonville. They deliver, service, issues that arise, all while you're putting money right back into the community. Stop wasting time and think Troby's first when you think of home appliances on Plaza Drive right behind Hawthorne Bank.
Ready to upgrade your patio for those football watch parties? Call Ethan Young with 2-3 Construction Services to get started today. He can create a fun patio area complete with a fire pit in case it gets a bit chilly for one of those Wildcat or Chiefs fall nights. If a new driveway or floor for the shop is part of your upgrade, he will help you there as well. Call Ethan today at 816-533-2119 and 2-3 Construction Services.
In motion they go. They're going to hand off to Morris. He gets around the end, gets inside the 15, and then is wrapped up by a lot of blue hats and taken down. Going to bring up second down at about 3. So 5:50 to go here, first half.
Morris takes it to the 16-yard line. Action
Morris down to the 16-yard line.
6-yard gain on the play. Play comes in for the Tigers.
So second down and 4-ish, maybe 5. Two backs flank Westfall, and they're going to hand it through to Hong. Hong not going to get there. Going to bring up third down and 4. Nowhere to go. Cats again cut it off, brings up third down and 4. And Cats have done a good job kind of slowing down the run after that first drive. And Warrensburg has been on fire with the pass. We got a third down and 4 coming up with 4:55 and counting. Two wide receivers to your left, two to your right. Shotgun formation for Westfall. On third down, and he's looking to throw. He gets it out in the flats. Has it complete to Munsterman out of the backfield. So Munsterman, the linebacker, comes in as a, like, slot back and gets 5 or 6 yards and a first down, and it'll be first and goal now at the 10-yard line. So first and goal from the 10. So first and 10, but first and goal. So Munsterman still in there with Westfall. Both of them sophomores in the backfield. Two wide receivers to your left, two to your right. And they're going to hand off for Munsterman, and he barrels forward inside the 5 to the 4. So second and goal down to the 4. And we've talked about it, Gary, in this one, kind of ad nauseum about these two teams in the next couple of years. All the youngsters they got playing out there. It is the second and goal from the 4 now. Westfall and Munsterman, and he slides down, lost his footing. I see a host of little Tigers coming up the stairs, Gary. So, third down and goal to go for the Tigers here. Get the play from the sideline from Coach Cavanaugh. Westfall and Munsterman in the backfield. Two wide receivers to your left, two to your right on third and goal. Looking over to the sideline for his play. Back into the shotgun formation. Switch sides is Reynolds with three on the play clock. And they snap it with one and nowhere to go. Again, Cats cut down Munsterman. And it'll bring up a fourth and goal from about the four. And now Warrensburg's got a solid kicker, too. Do they bring in the kicker here? Do they go for it on fourth down? We will see here in just a second. And here comes the field goal unit.
You'll say a nine-play drive that's taken up quite a bit of time. You want to get some points out of this, just like the Cats wanted to. So
here we go on fourth down. They are going to mark it at about the 10. So it'll be nothing more than an extra point attempt here, basically distance-wise for Henry. Snap, hold, kick. It is good, but false start, I think, on Warrensburg. That's what the Cats were pointing, nevertheless. It is a false start. Westfall was pointing the other way, so we'll push it back 5 yards. He had plenty of leg on that one.
I was going to say, he doesn't need to have to worry about that 5 yards, but it gets in your head a little bit, though. You kicked one now.
So going to bring up a field goal attempt from the 15, 16-yard line. Going to be a 26-yard attempt by Henry here. There's a high snap. Kick is up. Kick is good. And Warrensburg leads it 17-14. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back with more after this.
Wellness is the state or condition of ideal physical and mental health. We at the Wellness Counseling Center are passionate helpers. From the foundations of love, grace, kindness, and joy, we hope to humbly encourage others to embrace their self and find peace. Because when I is replaced by we, even illness can become wellness. Call us at 816-974-7378 and set up an appointment so we can change your I into a we.
All right, welcome back. 2:02 to go here in the first half. I was teasing Gary a little bit. I said I saw some little Tigers coming up here, and I am blessed to have the Rams, third and fourth grade, three of the Rams from the third and fourth grade flag football team. Had a game last night, played Coach Cavanaugh's son last night. We got Kendrick and Houston Morris up here, Braxton Grammer, and then we got soccer star Eli Smith back here in the background as well. So be thinking about these names in about 7 or 8 years, folks, because you're going to hear them on the high school football and basketball fields. I promise you that.
That was a nine-play drive that ended with a field goal. Took 5 minutes and 15 seconds off the clock. Ended with the field goal by number three, Rylan Henry.
So now the Cats, you almost got a score here if you're the Cats, because Warrensburg's going to get the ball at half. You don't want them to allow them a two-for-one opportunity. Cats going to take it from their own 5 to the 10. That is Inge at the 20. Sidesteps a defender up to the 25. And a host of helmets from Warrensburg take him down with 1:54 to go here in the first half. So 1:54 to go here, first half. Cats with the lead. Or, sorry, Tigers with the lead. I guess it is a cat, too.
Yeah, they only have two timeouts left. They had to use one early in the half, and so you know, the nice thing about it is the play clock stops with first down, so they can do it. See what they've got to bring, what type of plays they've got for a minute and 54 seconds left to at least get maybe in field goal range to tie it up. You'd at least like to tie it up, if not take the lead.
So here we go, first and 10 from their own 25 for the Cats. Out of the huddle, they're going to go single back set. They're going to probably run a guy in motion here, and that will be Baker, and he's going to stay. They're going to fake the handoff. Formation penalty on the Cats and caught by Reynolds, but I think this one's going to be coming back And Reynolds a little shaken up on the play. Maybe it came down on that ankle. Or maybe caught a helmet to the knee. So I believe that one was a procedure penalty on the Cats. They were still moving. Yeah, illegal shift is what they're going to call on it. So first and 10, ball at their own 25-yard line. We got one of our great sponsors back there from the pregame show, Brad Sainer, Farmers Insurance agent back there as well. We got all kinds of folks up here. We're going to have Travis Britz, assistant coach for the Oklahoma State Cowboys and newly inducted Harrisonville Hall of Famer tonight up here at halftime. It's going to be like Grand Central Station at halftime, Gary.
That is.
But we like it like that.
We love it like that.
So first and 15, ball at their own 20. Split backs in the backfield. They're going to hand off for Reynolds. Reynolds bounces to the outside. Going to get back to about the 25. Rolled up on by Gavin Wynn. Going to bring up a second down and 11. So we got four of it back, 120 to go. Now a whistle and a timeout called on the field by Warrensburg. Now Warrensburg's thinking, hey, we may get the ball back in good field position here.
Well, they also were subbing, and they were getting ready to run a play, and they were going to have 12 men on the field, so it was going to be a penalty anyway, so why not go ahead and stop the clock? It serves two purposes for them if they can stop them and have a short field.
We'll take a quick 30-second timeout. We'll be right back after this.
Just got done running a bunch of quotes. Why would anyone want their quotes done here? Fast quotes, accurate quotes, family owned and operated.
Well, tell me more. What do they offer?
Commercial, auto, home, life? Here, scan the QR code. I gotta get back to running.
All right.
Welcome back to Harrisonville, Missouri at Moore Memorial Stadium. The Harrisonville Wildcats and the Warrensburg Tigers.
Reynolds in the shotgun is looking to pass. He's going to chuck it downfield and overthrows his target. Now it is third down and 11 coming up with 109 to go. So they put Reynolds in the backfield. Reynolds has played quarterback before, but now you got a third down and long, and Warrensburg has a timeout left, and they get to keep that one in their pocket here. On a third and 11 from their own 24-yard line for the Cats. So I like the different look. However, now you're in a situation where if you don't get a first down here, Warrensburg's going to get the ball back in probably solid field position, and they've shown they can go down and quick score.
Yeah, but Nate made the right choice there. His receiver was covered. So.
And now a timeout called by the Wildcats. So 109 to go here in the first half, and the Wildcats trail by three, and they'll have a big third down coming up when we come back after this.
Hey, you ready? Hey, grab that right there. Are you ready? Oh. Is you ready?
Ready.
You say you ready.
Oh.
Whole squad ready.
Ready.
Is you ready?
Huh?
Are you ready?
Ready.
Is you ready? Whole squad ready. We came here to see Jet, what you got? No, no, no. Not on my watch.
No way.
Bring what you got, I'm going to the top.
Hey.
You can bring what you got, I'm going to the top.
All right, welcome back. Wildcats trail by 3:109 to go here, first half. And we await this third down play from the Cats. Big third down for the Cats right here, with Warrensburg going to get the ball back at the half. Two wide receivers to the near side. Blown back in the backfield is Moore. They're going to go in motion with Reynolds. He's going to wrap around and go back in motion. They're going to fake the handoff, look to throw. Mitchell still looking to throw. Sideline route caught. Close to a first down. Great job of the toe tap by Baker up to the 34. Watch this replay on the sideline. Great catch. So fourth down and a yard. Looks like Cats might go for it here on fourth down with 1:03 to go.
play in the first half.
So most of their plays have been positive. The only negative ones was when they were trying to pass and they got sacked. So
in motion, they're going to go with Moore. Into the backfield he goes. Showing blitz was Munsterman there. And a whistle and a timeout called by the Cats on fourth down and one as it was getting ready to run out. Might have been trying to draw him off a little bit right there as well. So fourth down and a yard coming up. Another timeout. We'll just keep it right here. Had a couple of timeouts and commercials. Want to do thank our great sponsors of the Wildcats on 4Ts. We've got a lot of great sponsors. And do you stick with it and go for it, Gary? I mean, at this situation.
Well, you know, if you don't make it, you really give Warrensburg a short field. If you do make it, really, what are you gaining? Because you're still going to have, you know, possibly 60 yards to go with less than a minute to go. So the clock will stop if he makes the first down. The clock will stop if he doesn't. So, you know, Warrensburg's not going to have to take a timeout. Looks like they made the decision. They were trying to draw him off sides. They weren't successful. Now they're going to punt. Now, the one thing that I'm sure Warrensburg is very well aware of, Nate Reynolds is in the backfield. He's only got to get 1 yard. He likes to run that occasionally, that kind of a bootleg then kick.
We'll talk about it after this play on fourth down. Fourth and one coming up.
I was going to say they're short people.
I was going to say there are very many guys on that line of scrimmage. Here we go on fourth and one. Reynolds has it, and he's going to boot it away.
Good punt.
Nice punt. Nobody back inside the 30 to the 25. It's going to roll dead at the 21, out of bounds with 52.1 seconds to go. I was chuckling because I had that exact conversation with Coach Cavanaugh before the game, because if you remember right, last year they went for fake punts at least twice in the game against Warrensburg last year and picked up massive yardage with Jace Reynolds. So I laughed because I was like, fourth and one, here's that opportunity for him. And you saw Kavanaugh wasn't taking any chances. He didn't even put anybody back.
Didn't have anybody back. They didn't even rush the punter. They had people along the line and on the outside to make sure that he didn't.
And he said, and Coach Kavanaugh, to his credit, watched the game film from last year, and he said, we worked on that plenty in practice this week. They're going to go in motion with it. Low snap taken by Morris. Morris going to get to the outside. And flag. That one's going to come back as a hold in there. So Morris with a big gain up to about the 29-yard line. So 45 seconds to go. It is a hold on the Tigers. So push him back here. That spot foul pushes him back in the side of the 15 to the 14. It's going to bring up a first and 17 for the Tigers. Be interested to see what they do here on first down. Maybe if they looks like they're lined up in the victory formation, they may just
run it out
here. And it looks like that is what they're going to do. And I wondered, let's say maybe they take one shot downfield. It looked like they took their shot on that first down, didn't like what it was. It was downed inside. And they won't even have to snap it again. Play clock didn't start. 25 seconds to go in the half, 29 on your play clock. So Cats are already headed to the locker room, some of the Cats here on the near side. Warrensburg starting to make that walk over to the middle school. So we're getting ready to go to halftime. So we'll send it to half. We will have a timeout. We'll come back with our 2-3 Construction Services halftime show. We got all kinds of guests lined up for you. We got the Rams flag football team. We got Brad Sainer. We've got Travis Britz. We're going to have some fun at halftime right after this.
Life is full of surprises. And big or small, they often come when you least expect them. So when life gives you lemons or lemonade, it's good to know that someone's got your back.
Whatever ups and downs come your way, we'll get you the tools you need to tackle them. After all, we're built for the unexpected. Commerce Bank. Challenge accepted.
There's always something new going on at the Cider House. Cooking classes, special events, Airbnb, Granny Faye's pie and sandwich shop, and more. Our upcoming farm-to-table dinner dates are September 17th, October 15th, November 19th, and December 17th. The shop is open Tuesday through Friday from 10 to 3, with lunch served from 11 to 2. Mums, pumpkins, and fall decor are coming in daily. Visit our website, www.thesiderhouseevents.com, for tickets and more information. We hope to see you soon. Go Cats!
One of the scariest tasks is taking your car to a mechanic. The best mechanics are in Harrisonville at Colby's Car Clinic. Colby's has expanded his shop and has ASC certified mechanics, the latest equipment to keep your vehicle running smooth all year long. Colby's Car Clinic takes the fear out of getting your car fixed. So call Colby today at 816-380-3000 to schedule an appointment, or head to the Big Blue Building behind O'Reilly's.
Work late? Kids got a game. Late night hunger? Good news, Domino's of Harrisonville is open until midnight or later every day. Instead of making a late night dinner or going through another takeout, order the Domino's app and pick up or even have it delivered. Dinner for the whole family, one click away on the Domino's app. Don't forget the garlic knots in dessert when you order. Domino's, your late night pizza stop.
Football is here, which means fall is coming fast. Fall means family fun at Red Barn Ranch. Come enjoy the corn maze, giant slides, corn pit, wagon ride, pedal tractors, food, all the pumpkins, and more. Mark your calendars. Opening day is September 17th. After the 17th, they are open Friday to Sunday through Halloween. Check their Facebook or website for festival and vendor dates. Red Barn Ranch on Jefferson Parkway, just north of Harrisonville.
With a wide array of services including massage therapy, acupuncture, cranial sacral therapy, Schroeder Chiropractic has you covered. The doctors and therapists will make sure you are feeling yourself in no time with quality care. Just off the historic Harrisonville Square on Wall Street, Schroeder Chiropractic is conveniently located in the heart of our town. With appointments on Tuesdays and Thursdays and walk-ins the rest of the week, stop in and see them and let them put you on the road to a healthier you.
At Signature Will and Trust, owner and managing attorney Danielle Scavuzzo and attorneys Salvatore Scavuzzo and Brendan Barker tailor estate plans to fit your individual and family needs. A properly executed estate plan protects you and your loved ones in the event of your incapacity or death. Now is the time to call and schedule an appointment for a free consultation with Signature Will and Trust at 816-237-8555. The choice of a lawyer is an important decision and should not be based solely on advertisements.
Don't trim your own trees, risking life and limb. Call the experts at Stoico's Tree Service. From a simple trimming to massive removals and anything in between, Stoico's Tree Service has over 50 years of experience taking care of whatever's the root of your problem. Licensed, insured, and offering free estimates today. Let the experts take care of you. Find them online at StoicoTreeService.com or call them at 816-838-7042.
People with disabilities deserve to live happy, fulfilling lives that enable freedom, independence, and safety. And that's why this message is so important. Casco Area Workshops are where people with disabilities have the benefit of a safe work environment that gives them the freedom and independence to work with and alongside people who see beyond their disability.
Life is full of surprises.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Harrisonville, Missouri. It is halftime on our 2-3 Construction Services halftime show. You're looking for a patio to watch those fall Chiefs games. Ethan can take care of you with 2-3 Construction Services. Gary, you've been feverishly adding up some stats. Let us know what you came up with.
For Harrisonville, they had 68 yards rushing, 151 yards passing for 219 total yards. 28 plays, took 14 minutes off the clock. For Warrensburg, they had 73 yards rushing, 67 yards passing, only 140 yards total offense, 19 plays, took 10 minutes off the clock. However, they are prevailing right now at halftime, 17-14. Had a 6-yard touchdown run by Kreisel, a 26-yard touchdown, touchdown reception by Kreisel, 26-yard touchdown run by Morris, and then that 26-yard field goal by Henry, giving them 17 points. The scoring for Harrisonville was a 1-yard touchdown run by Reynolds, and then the 77-yard touchdown reception by Drogi. Extra points were all good, again making it 17-14 with Warrensburg prevailing. Harrisonville's controlled the clock, controlled the yardage, but they just have not been able to control the offense of Warrensburg.
Yeah, and, you know, both teams felt each other out there in the first quarter. A long drive by the Cats, a quick answer by Warrensburg. Cats answer fast with the one-play drive. And then it kind of stalled out for both sides after that, so they kind of got familiar with each other. You said it. Now the Cats are on the opposite side of where they were last week. They got to get a stop coming out of halftime.
Yeah, and really the difference in this game is when they were down inside the red zone and had four plays and they couldn't prevail, end up getting a long sack. Warrensburg got the sack. We tried the field goal, missed the field goal, was wide right. And so that's really the difference in a ball game. Harrisonville's got more yards than Warrensburg. We've been able to drive the ball. We've just got to be able to stop Warrensburg.
And that's kind of been a hampering effect of the Cats all year. They've been able to drive. They haven't been able to finish. See if they can change that in the second half. We got a lot lined up for you here at halftime. We're going to have Travis Britz after the break. We've also got Brad Sainer. We got the Rams third and fourth grade flag team over here. We got all kinds of fun. We're going to take a quick timeout. We'll bring in Travis Britz right after this. All right, we're going to bring in Travis Britz. Travis, first of all, congratulations. Hall of Fame nominee tonight, and well-deserved for you, Travis.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
One of the things we talked about here in the pregame show was when you scored the touchdown against Kearney, and people always laugh that their ears are still ringing because I yelled it so loud.
Right.
But was that probably one of the funnest times in high school for you, is scoring that touchdown?
I mean, that was a great one. I think there's so many to choose from. You know, going to the Moberly game, that was a reigning game, and just getting out of that game with a win was pretty sweet in itself too. So there's a tons of games, but I think the most memorable ones were those big plays right there.
Well, Travis, tell everybody kind of what you're doing now. You've had a nice road from high school. You went to K-State. You were on the squad for Tampa Bay in the off season.
Yes, sir.
And then now you're coaching?
Yeah. So if you know, ever since college I've always wanted to be around the game of football. It's given me everything that I've ever dreamed of. And it's given me, you know, so many opportunities in life. So now I'm trying to give back, and I'm coaching, and you know, I went from Kansas State as a graduate assistant that full time at ACU, and now I'm at Oklahoma State helping with the D line. So It's rewarding to give things back to, you know, the things you learn along the way, and just seeing those guys develop and grow is pretty cool.
Well, you know, we got a couple of youngsters over here, and Braxton, my son, who's now in second grade, I said, hey, you know who that is over there? And I told him what you did, and he goes, he played for the dang Tampa Bay Buccaneers. So it's fun, and I'm sure
you enjoy
to be able to do stuff like
Absolutely.
That.
Absolutely. It's a blast.
So. We were talking before the game. How many – I know you started here at Harrisonville blocking extra points and field goals. How many did you ultimately get at K-State? Because I remember several, but I can't tell you how many.
Yeah, I got five total, and four in 2013, which – which is a pretty good year. Now they've changed the rules, so it's probably not as easy because you can't rush the snapper anymore in college football. But, you know, it was a great thing, and it was a great moment for that whole year.
Well, I know, you know, during your season, during your years here, you got an opportunity to, or Zach got an opportunity to play with you.
Yes.
And then obviously come over to K-State, be a member of the team, obviously. And you're a big part of why he wanted to come to K-State, obviously. Really enjoyed his time over there. And so you should be proud of yourself because you had a lot to do with a lot of people in this school and other schools, obviously.
I appreciate it so much. That means a lot. It really does.
And, you know, I've known him since he was in high school. He was Ange's A-plus tutor the 1 year as well, and always got to talk with his mom at the parents as teachers little play groups on Mondays or Wednesdays. We always talked about what Travis was doing and stuff. So it's great that you got to come back tonight. And I think you got to head back to Stillwater. You got a game tomorrow?
We got a game tomorrow.
Who,
so
who you got tomorrow?
We have Arkansas Pine Bluff. So okay. They're a good-looking squad. I think they're averaging about 60 points on offense a game. So we got a good test. We just got to take care of our job.
Well, obviously, you're going to be part of that defense that's going to stop that.
Absolutely.
And it would be remiss to not mention your parents. Obviously, your parents have done well with you. Yeah. And the rest of the family, Janice and Tom, your parents. And obviously, you've got a relative on the field tonight. You
Absolutely.
Might tell everybody who that is.
Shout out to Sam and Drew. You know, Drew had an excellent catch and got to run down the sideline tonight. That was awesome. But, you know, just seeing the family atmosphere. And I think that's what most of Harrisonville is. You know, it's just a bunch of families who come together and that generations after generations just come and play, and that's pretty cool.
Well, Travis, we're glad you got to come up here and chat with us for a couple minutes. Have a safe trip back to Stillwater tonight, and good luck tomorrow.
Thank you so much.
Only tomorrow, though, okay?
Absolutely.
And Gary was talking about that. You've got K-State in a couple of weeks, so that'll
November
probably be
29th.
That'll be a little bit weird for you, I'm sure.
Absolutely.
So
yeah, it'll be different on the other side of those sidelines.
Well, congratulations again on your induction into the Hall of Fame tonight, and look forward to watching you guys play tomorrow.
Thank you so much.
All right,
thanks
a lot.
Travis.
That is Travis Britz of the Wildcats, former Wildcat, and now member of the Hall of Fame. We're going to take a timeout. We'll be back right after this. All right, welcome back. In the booth with us now is one of our great sponsors. You know, we've talked about all of our sponsors up and down the list, and Brad's one of those that's been with us since the beginning. Brad, you know, I started coming in 2016 pestering you to see if you wanted to...
That's an understatement.
to see if you wanted to be a sponsor on this, but seeing all of this, this is why you do it, because you want to give back to your community.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. I mean, what you guys have done, I think, is fantastic. I mean, you guys have grown this thing to be – I mean, I walked up here, and I was like, holy cow, they've gotten a lot bigger. So, no, it's fantastic what you're doing. It's pretty great as a sponsor to be able to give back a little bit. I know it's not a lot, but what we can do is a little bit to at least give back to Harrisonville because, you know, I mean, this city deserves this, and this town loves their football, man.
Well, and, you know, we love having you on board. You're our pregame sponsor this year. Braxton lets everybody know you need to prepare for an insurance quote. We call Brad Sainer.
That's right. I'll tell you what, Braxton, I don't know how much I owe him. Do you get royalties, Braxton? So I'm not sure. But he did a great job on my commercial. But yeah, no, I don't really want to use your time as a plug for my business, but I do have an insurance agency with Farmers here in town. So,
that's why we do it, Brad. Is we also want people to give back to you guys. You know, we have great sponsors up and down the lineup. And, you know, you're one of them. You've been around since the beginning, and we're glad that you are part of it.
Well, I appreciate it. And, yeah, if anybody ever wants anything, give me a holler, and I'm happy to see what we can do for them.
I'm looking, and, Travis, if you don't leave for just a minute, Travis, I want you to hear this. 6 days ago, Brad made a Facebook post, okay? It was actually when Mizzou was playing last week. And then he made a comparison about SEC and K-State and whether or not, you know. And so I just had to remind him to be careful what he says on Facebook. So I'll let you defend yourself, Brad.
Well, I mean, whatever you see online is not always true. That is not always true. That's a fake Facebook account.
Well, here's the thing, and to joke around and have a little bit of fun with it, you know, I thought Mizzou was going to go over and have a solid game. I didn't expect to get blown out, but I'm going to put that on the Mizzou coaching staff because K-State was in their 3-3-5 defense. I think they thought they could run against K-State. When the run wasn't there, Drinkwitz didn't know what to do, and then we ended up with the 40-12 drubbing, and I'm sure Travis enjoyed that a little bit.
Well, I'm just glad I got thrown under the bus. I think that's fantastic, and now an alum from K-State loves me, so this is fantastic.
There aren't too many times I feel small, Brad, but as you can see, standing next to Travis Britz, we feel a little bit small.
This is great, so and the only way out is through him.
Oh, goodness. Well, guys, we're having fun up here. We got about 7-8 minutes left before we go to our second half, and I'm going to take about a two-minute timeout. I got some little ones up here I think that really want to talk, and they're all excited. I think they're excited and nervous all at the same time, so we'll see how that goes.
Braxton wants to talk? No way.
Takes after
his dad.
I was going to say, after his dad. Absolutely.
All right, we'll take a timeout. We'll be back here in just a couple minutes with the Rams.
Church & Dwight is one of the world leaders in household and personal care products, and we want you to join our team in Harrisonville. You'll get the chance to work with winning brands that consumers love. We offer starting salaries ranging from $20.50 to $39 per hour, depending on experience. A signing bonus of $2,500. Comprehensive benefits, paid time off, and every other weekend is a three-day weekend. To apply, go to churchdwight.com and click on careers.
When you're searching for insurance, call an agent in town that can protect you. Call CBSK for auto, life, renter's boat, ATV, or any other weekend toy you want covered. CBSK Insurance is an auto owner's affiliate, so call and talk to Summer, Randy, Amanda, or Chandra. They can give you a quote and get you covered quickly and easily. Business coverage is available as well. Call them today at 816-380-3800 or visit them online at www.cpskinsurance.com and let your local agents go to work for you.
All right, welcome back. It is halftime here. We got about 6 or 7 minutes to go here on our halftime show. And, you know, everybody's going to give me grief for this, and it is what it is. But my son's a Wildcat, or was a Wildcat, is now a Tiger. And he is playing in Warrensburg in the 3rd and 4th grade flag division as a 2nd grader. They had a game last night, and what was awesome about the game was there was a lot of 3rd and 4th grade people there. There was a lot of people from the Warrensburg community there. On one side, you have Coach Kavanaugh and his kids. You have the head basketball coach's son. On the other side, you have the UCM head football coach's son, or daughter, I should say, sorry. You also have the Morris's little cousins on that team, Xavier Morris from Warrensburg. You have a couple of principals' kids. It was fun there last night. So I've got a couple of the boys, and I got a soccer player up here. Why don't you guys introduce yourselves?
I'm Braxton Grammer.
I'm Houston Morris.
I'm Eli Smith.
So those are the three. First, I'll ask Braxton, because he's kind of old hat at this. Braxton, what's it been like for you to become a part of the Warrensburg community?
It felt good.
So are you enjoying being a Warrensburg Tiger and a Ram this year?
Yes.
Okay. Why don't you tell us a little bit about the game last night?
So, if it would have came down to everything, if they would have got, if they would have not got 4 pick sixes, we would have went into overtime. So.
It was a good game, pretty solid game. Houston, tell me, you know, they keep calling you Julio. Why they call you Julio?
Because I'm great at football, and I'm the best one on the team because I prove it.
Well, I like that you have had a great year so far this year. You had a touchdown last night. Braxton had a touchdown. You had 2 touchdowns. Braxton had a touchdown. We also have Eli Smith here. Eli, tell us about your soccer team.
Well, it's very good, but we have
of a person that's really mean to us.
Well, that is crazy. Oh, we found one. Kendrick. Kendrick, our other member of the Rams team. Kendrick, tell me how your season's gone so far with the Rams. You enjoying it?
Yeah.
That's what I usually get out of a kid when I ask him a comment. They get one or two. But, hey, all I know is I love Houston's. I love his excitement, exuberance, and his confidence. He says, I'm the best one on the team. I love it. So, boys, I'm glad you got to come up here and see this. And good luck the rest of the year. Go get them. You guys want any last words, Braxton?
Ooh, I know one. Go Tigers! Go Tigers! Go Tigers! Go Tigers!
We may or may not be outnumbered up here tonight, Gary. But nevertheless, it's been fun. These four are going to go back and sit down and have a good time on the second half. I'm going to take a timeout, take a breather, and we'll be back with our second half right after this.
Football season is here, and cold weather is sure to follow. Time to head to Young's Auto Repair and get your vehicle ready for winter. Flush the radiator, get an oil change, and make sure the heater is ready to keep your family rolling down the road all winter. If something else is wrong with your vehicle, bring it in and let Young's diagnose the problem to get you back on the road. Young's Auto, across the road from Young's Tire and Wheel Center on South Commercial Street.
Hey, Harrisonville. Say hi to several friendly faces from your neighborhood Culver's, home of delicious Butterburgers and fresh frozen custard that's always cooked to order. Stop by and try our double Butterburger with cheese made with fresh, never frozen beef, seared on the grill as you order on a lightly buttered and toasted bun. And for dessert, grab a rich and creamy fresh frozen custard made in small batches all day long. See you there. Go Wildcats.
Thanks for joining us on our halftime show here tonight. We had all kinds of guests on the 2-3 Construction Services halftime show. We're having fun up here in the booth, but we're going to take a minute and be a little bit serious, and we're getting ready to have our mental health minute, which is so important. So we're going to send it to our mental health minute, one of our great new features on 4Ts. We'll be back right after this.
Hello, welcome to the Mental Health Minute, brought to you by the Wellness Counseling Center, LLC. I'm your friendly neighborhood couples and family therapist, Jeff Camp, and today we're talking about coping skills. So what is a coping skill? A coping skill can be any kind of strategy or activity that helps you to relax or to help you escape from the problems at hand. So let's explore each one together. Physical type coping skills. This can include anything from walking, going on a little hike, hitting the gym, or even just doing something physical with your kids or pets. Escape type coping skills. Escape type coping skills can include playing video games, watching a movie, reading a book, or doing anything that helps you break the norm for yourself. Social type coping skills. These include talking to someone else, joining some kind of group or social organization, or even talking to your therapist. That's what we're here for. Relaxation type coping skills. These include anything that helps you to relax and take your mind off the stressors at hand. They could include several of the other ones we've mentioned already, like reading, going for a walk, switching up your location for the moment, or even just gardening or doing something that just helps take your mind off of things. Creative type coping skills. Personally, I love doing this one as well.
Perfect.
Creative type coping skills can involve many different ways of expressing yourself, including dance, cooking, listening to music, or even just expressing yourself creatively and throwing something down on a page to see what comes out of it. These have been the 5 different types of coping skills. I encourage you this week to go out and try something new, or maybe blow the dust off of something that you haven't done in a while. And while sometimes we're not able to access maybe a physical type coping skill, we might be able to do a social or relaxation one. So make sure to have a very diverse list of coping skills for yourself. And go out there, and I encourage you, as Jeff from the Wellness Counseling Center, LLC, to be well.
All right, that was our Mental Health Minute, brought to you by the Wellness Counseling Centers. Your mental health, everybody's mental health, it should be at the forefront of your minds. Just be friendly, be kind to everybody. Open a door, hold a door for somebody. Tell somebody good morning, hey, good afternoon, good evening, whatever it might be. Your mental health and everybody's mental health should be at the front of your mind, and where you're glad to partner with the Wellness Counseling Centers and have the Mental Health Minute every week. It is a great addition to the 4Ts broadcast as we are getting ready for second half action. And what a fun halftime show we had, Gary, and I love it. You brought up, Hey, I'm a Mizzou fan too, and I read that and I was like, oh, Brad. And then usually when Brad posts something like that, it does go pretty sour quick. It quite did on him last Saturday, and be able to bring it up in front of a K-State alum, and that was fun.
Absolutely. Well, and all I responded to it was, I said, be careful, Brad, because I get his posts because we're friends on Facebook. So, you know, it was a great time, great half, and we're starting the second half.
Little short kick going to be taken about the 20 by Morris to the 25. 30, cuts back 35, 40, not quite. Boy, down by Bechtel.
And they've had on kickoffs, they've had great returns. They've been almost at the 40 every time.
Yeah, Xavier Morris has been a star on kick returns for Warrensburg. So let's see what adjustments each squad make. Gosh, I feel like the first half was an hour ago.
Well, and you feel like the first half was going to go real fast, and then it slowed down tremendously.
So here we go, start the second half. Shotgun formation. Hong back there with him in the backfield on first down and 10. And they're going to hand off to Hong, and he's going to barrel forward to the 41-yard line. Espen Glenn comes up after the initial contact. First contact by Wyatt Smith. So Wyatt Smith in on the tackle.
So second down and 8. Officials for the ball, the 41-yard line. Action remains here on the near side.
Second down and 8. 11:29 to go here. Third quarter. We're just underway. Two wide receivers to your left, two to your right. Hong in the backfield along with Westfall on second and 8. They're going to go in motion with Morris. They're going to hand off to Morris. Morris is going to try to get around the end. He gets around the end, cuts back to the 50. Inside the 50 to the 45, down to the 42. They're going to knock him down at the 44. We're going to mark him. But a big chunk of yardage down into Cat territory.
15-yard run.
So 11:10 to go here in the third quarter.
MRVC West matchup between Warrensburg and Harrisonville. And it gets off, here we go.
So shotgun formation, two wide receivers, far side, one to the left. They're going to hand off to Hong. No, keeping himself as Westfall. Now he's calling for blockers. He's got a lane. He gets inside the 40 to the 35 and hammered down at the 30. Lawful in on the tackle. So another first down for the Bird. Down to the 30 with 10:40 to go. So Warrensburg comes out of the gates firing on all cylinders all the way down to the 30-yard line.
And that was a good read by him to pull it and to bring it out this way. I don't know if it was a called play or if it was just a read, but good play.
Westfall, he's got his man in motion, and they're going to go
double reverse
and back the other way. Nowhere to go. Cats were able to read that one. Cale Weber in on the tackle of Morris at the 30, so no gain on the double reverse. They went from Kreisel to Morris.
Almost had him in the backfield. Couldn't quite make, he maybe was able to make a good jab step, but almost got him for a 5-yard loss.
Morris so shifty and quick in the backfield. Low center of gravity there. A little Barry Sanders-ish looking. Two wide receivers left, two to the right. Shotgun formation, 9:50 to go here in the third quarter. Nowhere to go for Hong. Good wrap
good,
up in the backfield.
Good. Cale Weber again in the backfield.
That's his second tackle for a loss tonight in the backfield. And that's right when the Cats have needed a couple big plays. They've got them on defense. Brings up a third down and long. Now maybe you bring a little bit of pressure on Westfall, the sophomore. Let him get a little bit of happy feet. Maybe sail a throw or throw a pick here. They're going to go in motion with Morris. And they're going to fake the handoff. Rollout is Westfall. He's going to chuck it. And he's got his man, Kreisel, inside the 10. And a first and goal. So that did not go the way the Cats wanted. 21 quick yards by Westfall to Kreisel. And it's first and goal down to the 10-yard line.
And that's 82 yards on 6 receptions for Kreisel.
Westfall looked good as a sophomore quarterback out there tonight, Gary.
He is. He's not had an incomplete pass.
Wide receiver one way, two the other way. Ball up the middle it goes to Hong to about the 7. Ball is inside the 10. Second and goal coming up. William Crispin up 28-3 on St. Joe Central at the half. Two wide receivers set to the far side, one to the near side. In motion, they're going to go with Morris again. Fake the handoff to Morris. Now Westfall going to try to keep it himself. Looks like he lost his footing on the cutback. Going to get up to about the six. Bring up third and goal from the six. So third down and goal from the six.
Yeah, Westfall has played a very good game tonight. He's thrown darts when he's needed to. But like I said, he's 7 for 7 and almost 90 yards. But most of those have gone to Kreisel. So if I was a defense, I think I would be maybe almost double-teaming Kreisel.
And Kreisel's in the slot. You know, in motion with Morris. Fake the handoff to Morris. Westfall going to look. He's still looking. Overthrows. And just in time, Gary jinxes him. He overthrows it. Brings up fourth down. Decision time for the Tigers. You go for the three. Make it a six-point game. Or do you go ahead and go for it here on fourth down from the six and pin the Cats deep in their own territory if you don't get it? So a big fourth down coming up for both sides. Decision time here. That slow walk over there.
Going to go for it.
Usually coaches have a play just for this situation, Gary. Let's see if they do here. Shotgun formation.
I would watch Kreisel.
And they're going to go. Look to throw over the middle. Incomplete. Quick throw. Good pressure. And the Cats get the stop they need on back-to-back incompletions by Warrensburg. It is Cats ball thrown six after the stop. So the Cats defense tightens up and is able to cause.
If that's all it took, I would have said that a long time ago.
Right, understand that. 35-22 Odessa over Oak Grove and other scores. Just kind of scrolling down here, trying to find some other scores. Green Valley up 21-14 on Platte County. Pleasant Hill up 45-7 over Clinton in the third quarter. First down and 10 for the Cats. More in the backfield, along with Reynolds, and they're going to go right up the middle, and there's a flag immediately. So might be a hold, which not too far backwards they can go here. 7.5 to go here in the third.
They had 10 plays on that drive, took over 55 yards, 4 minutes and 30 seconds. Came out with no points on down. So they're waving off the flag. So it's going to be second down for the Cats.
And, you know, I like that call on you decline that penalty because makes it a second down. Reynolds on the carry that first down. I like the call there. You decline the penalty and you lose a down because you're only going to lose about 2.5 yards on a penalty anyway. So instead they take the down.
I think they were waving off. There was no penalty, is what they were doing.
Going to go in motion. Reynolds in the backfield. And again, another flag. Right up the middle they go, and Reynolds carries defenders up to the 12-yard line. So brings up second. It would be third down. See what they do here.
Illegal motion.
Illegal motion on the Cats. And they've called that a couple of times tonight. The Cats go with some unique motions where they do that swing around the running back in the backfield. And they've got a couple motion penalties on that tonight. So
second down and 13. That was only about a three-yard penalty half a distance to goal. So be second down. They've got third down over there, but it's going to be second down. There we go.
They flip it back. Well, no. Second down. And says second on the scoreboard. We'll see here. There we go. Flipped it back again. Clock will roll here. They're going to go in motion with Baker and fake the handoff. Throw it out in the flats for Reynolds. And Reynolds to the 20. He's got a man to beat to the 30. Drug down by Zach Munsterman up at the 34-yard line.
31-yard run for Reynolds. Or 31-yard reception, I'm sorry.
Well, that could be a run. They may call that a run, Gary. It was more of a lateral. It was still in the backfield. But he gets it up to the 34 and moves the chains. So it'll be a first and 10 for the Cats from their own 34-yard line. 6:35 to go here in the third. In motion, they're going to go with Reynolds this time. He wraps around, hand off for Moore. And Moore are going to go nowhere. They're going to call another penalty on the Cats.
And what's happening is, I've seen this several times, they haven't called it every time. Reynolds is moving towards the line when he's in motion, and he cannot do that until the ball is snapped.
Yes, and that's what they are getting. I was going to say the same thing. You can move in motion laterally, but you can't move towards the line of scrimmage. As soon as you do that and you're in motion and the snap, they're going to call you for a false start or the procedure penalty.
So we're going to have first down and 15 from the 29.
So we'll push them back. And so 17-14 the score, 6:15 to go here in the third. Split backs in the backfield. Under center is Mitchell. And they're going to fake the handoff, go on a counter for Reynolds. And Reynolds stays on his feet, spins out of a tackle up to the 40. And he's still on his feet, chucked out of bounds on the near side. Kreisel gets to him.
11-yard run.
And here's a replay on that. Gets a little chippy on the near side here. Kreisel and one of the Wildcats on the near sideline had a couple words for each other. Probably just asking each other where they're going to go eat dinner afterwards. Good replay there by James to get that on for us.
And that shows Reynolds' quickness and vision in the backfield, because he could have easily had a 4-yard loss there.
So second down and 4 coming up after the gain by Reynolds. And this time they're going to hand to Reynolds, and Reynolds
first down,
showing his power, a 5-yard run. And Gary, you talked about it, is that the time of possession could come back in the second half a little bit. There is a Tiger down on the field.
Yeah, 14 minutes in the first half, and now they've had it for about a little over 2 minutes here. So you're talking about 16 minutes of defense by Warrensburg so far in this game, and we've still got a quarter and a half to go. So and several of these guys play, especially some of the linemen and linebackers, they play both ways. And we've been pounding the ball. I mean, the first half we had 28 plays, and we've already had 4 plays, so 32 plays now. So
we have a timeout on the field. We'll see if they're going to get him up. They're not quite yet. So let's take a timeout as well. Cats.
Before every big purchase, you have to prepare. Prepare the easy way by calling Harrisonville's Farmers Insurance agent, Brad Sainer. Brad will make sure there are no holes in your coverage and take care of you with any life's mishaps. Prepare for great insurance coverage by calling Brad Sainer at 816-974-8105. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, ba-dum, bum, 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 bum.
When you need a part for your vehicle or farm equipment, it's good to have someone local. Harrisonville Auto Parts, stocked with Napa products, is your local provider. No need to go to a national chain and pay marked up prices. Instead, keep your money and business local with Harrisonville Auto Parts. Next time the headlight goes out, head over to Harrisonville Auto Parts and have them take care of you. Next to Young's Tire and Wheel Center on Commercial.
Welcome back. Brent Bellinger was the injured Warrensburg Tiger. He went off on his own power, so hopefully everything will be good with him.
Still, you know, you got the cramps that can still happen. It's kind of humid night. It's a little cooler, but still humid, and don't get enough of that water. I know every once in a while I drink a lot of unsweet iced tea. My kids give me a hard time at school all the time. They're like, "You're weird. You drink unsweet tea?" I'm like, "Yeah, I have to. It's just what I do. I don't drink coffee, so I drink unsweet tea." And sometimes I'll get a cramp in my foot just standing all day teaching. So
the Cats have an opportunity. They were able to stop Warrensburg on the downs in the red zone. They have an opportunity to take the length of the field and take a lead by 4 points. So
swing of momentum, chance for the Cats. Under center is Mitchell. They're going to go in motion with Baker. He stays out to the far side on the right side. They're going to hand it off for Reynolds. Reynolds spins out of the tackle, gets to the outside to the 50, strips another one to the 45-yard line. 10-yard gain. Watch this replay. He just pushes Othick right off his side. You could tell Othick was a little frustrated on that spin move and then initial contact there.
And, you know, that's instinct. That's not something you teach.
So quick 9 yards. It'll be second and one, not quite a first down. In motion, they're going to go with Baker from left to right, and he's going to kick off back to the outside. And now he's going to go in motion, and the second handoff, they thought it was going to Reynolds, and Mitchell pulls it back on that mesh play and gets a first down about 6 yards, and that's a Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center first down. Think Trobe's first.
And that's the third first down on this drive, and that was an excellent read by Mitchell. He pulled it. He didn't pitch it because they did have the pitch man, so he went ahead and took it up. All he needed was 1 yard. You know, you always think of down and distance. He was thinking down and distance to get the first down. Now they've got a first down and 10.
So first and 10 down to the 41-yard line. Cats on the move here. In motion, they go with Moore. And now they're going to hand off for Reynolds. Reynolds again to get outside feet. He gets that initial contact and then gets all the way up to the 31-yard line.
10-yard.
Not quite 10. Going to give him 9. Nope, they're going to move him. 10-yard run for Reynolds, and Reynolds is having a pretty solid game tonight.
14 carries, unofficially 70 yards. And that's the fourth first down on this drive that started on Harrisonville 6. Plus, he's got 71 yards in reception as well.
I feel like he's had way more yardage, but he's got 141
yards total offense.
So under center they go with Mitchell. And ball on the turf. He's going to dust it off, pick it up, try to throw it, gets it in the flats, caught. Moore, 20, inside the 15, and knocked down out of bounds. Zach Munsterman able to chase him down at about the 16-yard line, but good job. Watch Mitchell here make something out of nothing and gets it all the way down. And that is a – Ryan, did I say Zach? I told you how long before I call it Moore with the reception. And I said I was probably going to call him Zach at some point. That was Ryan Munsterman, and I probably called him Ryan or Zach a couple of times tonight. So, Ryan, I apologize.
And that was another first down.
Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center first down. Think Trobe's first when you think home appliances. Go in motion. This time they're going to hand off for Moore. He gets to the 15. Quick 2 yard hit. Going to bring up second down and about 8 for the Cats.
9 plays so far in this drive. They went from the 10 to the 15. 75 yards so far.
So a good drive put together by the Cats here, taking up a giant chunk of time as well.
But they need points.
Hand off for Moore inside the 10. See where they mark him. Going to bring him a third down and a couple. Gary definitely hit the nail on the head. You got to get points here. So 17-14 our score. Ball at the 10. Started at their own 6. 304 to play in the third. Wildcats break. To the line they go. Mitchell taking squad to the line. So third down and 3 coming up. Got to feel your 4-down territory here. We'll see. They do have a kicker. And they're going to hand off for Moore. And he breaks the tackle, dives forward to about the 8-yard line.
Number 25, Michael Moore, the volunteer, takes it to about the 8.
Bodies flying around over there. A Warrensburg Tiger on the ground.
I'm going to give him a yard on that play.
So give it to him at the 9. They got to get to about the 7. And see what the Cats decide to do here. So both teams, one team's gone forward here in the fourth, or the third, on fourth down. See if the Cats do. They got 7 seconds of play clock.
They just reset it. So
they reset the play clock, and Cats gonna go for it here, fourth and a pair.
Remember, this is exactly what Warrensburg did on the other end. We need to prevail here.
So Mitchell and Reynolds in the backfield, 2 wide receivers to your left, 1 to your right, on 4th and 2. And there's the handoff to Reynolds. Reynolds cuts back, breaks a tackle to the 5, to the house! House call, Nate Reynolds, from 10 yards out. That just shows you.
You got to see the replay. How many players had an opportunity to tackle him, and they weren't able to do so?
We'll see the replay here. Watch this run by Reynolds. Shows why he's such a good runner. Boom. One, two, three, four. Touchdown. Nate Reynolds, great run by the sophomore. And the Cats are up 20-17 after the Nate Reynolds house call. And here's the kick. It is up. It is good. Cats lead 21-17. We'll be right back after this.
You want the best price from the best dealership? At Max Motors, we make it easy. Purchase or order your next new vehicle at invoice pricing. We honor all AXZ and D plans, supplier pricing, and industry offers. At Max Motors, we guarantee to beat any dealer's online price by $500. Check out the Max Motors guarantee. Contact us for a hassle-free quote. Max Motors is the easiest place to buy a car with the highest trade-in values in the Midwest. MaxMotors.com. See dealer for details.
Take the struggle of making homemade pizza out of the equation. Go see Marshall and Stephanie Hamilton, the new owners of Harrisonville Papa Murphy's, and let them do the prep work. Daily specials, new calzones, fresh sides, creative fundraising, and limited time pizzas, there's something for the whole family. Don't forget win or lose discounts every Saturday after the game on your order or $20 or more. Simply type CATS50 after a win or CATS25 after a loss and save big with Papa Murphy's of Harrisonville.
All right, Gary, give us that scoring summary real fast.
And I was just telling Chad, that may be the turning point of the game. 12 plays, 94 yards, ate up 5 minutes and 15 seconds, which culminated on the 9-yard touchdown run by Reynolds to make the score 21-17, Harrisonville. And then we kick into the end zone. I'm telling you, that could be the turning point of the game.
That scoring summary brought to you by Lacey Dominic of Shelter Insurance. If you need a summary of your insurance coverages, call Lacey today. Looking at some of the scores, Center was up 28-0. Oak Grove and Odessa are in a good one, 43-29 in that ball game. Trying to give you some more. Pleasant Hill up 45-7, still on Clinton last we checked. So some good scores around the area. A lot of close games in the Kansas City area tonight as I was looking through, and I haven't got a lot of updates on some of these. See if we can get a refresh here. And they're going to hand off.
Ooh.
And nowhere to go. Good hit by the Cats. That was Cale Weber again on Morris.
And he's had a good game. He has had an excellent game tonight.
Well, second and eight coming up. 1:54 to go here in the third quarter. Westfall in the shotgun. Going to go in motion again with Morris. And they're going to hand off to Morris. Morris gets around that first contact, cuts it back, gets about four or five. Going to be close to a first down. Going to be about 2 yards short. Going to bring up third down and two with 1:25 to go here in the third.
Remember, they had a 10-play drive earlier to start the half and were unable to capitalize in the red zone. You know, that hurt them. This gave the Cats momentum at the touchdown. Plus, a lot of people, as I've said, playing both ways with Warrensburg.
So there we go, third down and two. They're going to hand off to Hong No, keeping himself Westfall, and now Westfall cuts back. He got to the 30, going to go to the 31-yard line. It'll be enough for a first down.
First down marker just about. On the stop again, number 14, Cale Weber. There's your signal, first and 10.
Westfall thought about tossing that one out to the outside. Thought otherwise. Fifty-ish seconds to go here in the third. 21-17, Cats with the lead. Two wide receivers to your left, to your right. Shotgun formation for the Cats in motion again with Morris from right to left. And they're going to fake the handoff out to the flats. Is Westfall to Hong. Hong to the 40. 45 pushed out of bounds near midfield. Close to a 20-yard gain, about an 18-yard gain. Ball to midfield with 32 seconds to go in the third.
That was Hong, wasn't it?
Yes. So Hong with the reception. Two wide receivers to your left, two to your right. Shotgun formation again in motion this time. Morris comes from the left to the right. And now looking to throw is Westfall. He's going to keep it himself. gets to the line of scrimmage, and the Cats toss him out of bounds on the far side. Good pursuit by the Cats. Polk on the far side and a couple other Cats. That could be the last play of this third quarter. Well, the clock stopped. Looked like they showed an incomplete pass. Did he get rid of it? The clock stops. Either that or he was out of bounds the way that the official on the far side marked it. Here we go on second and 10. Westfall to throw. Throws it in the flat. And he looks like he bounced that one incomplete. Brings up third down and 10 now. You know, I don't know what Gary did to take away Westfall's mojo, but he had not had an incomplete pass, and he has got four or three now here in the last two series. 9.7 seconds to go here. Third quarter, a third and 10 from midfield for the Tigers. In motion with Morris from right to left. Fake the handoff, looking to the flats, now looking to throw. They're going to chuck one deep. They got a man and overthrows him by just a yard or so. That was for Kreisel. Nope, actually, I don't believe so. That was Conley. So Conley had his man beat and just about a step too much. Conley just a junior. You look all over that Warrensburg side. Kreisel a junior. Conley a junior. Hong is a senior, of course. Morris is a senior. Westfall only a sophomore. Munsterman, Ryan, who's got some time in the backfield. High end over end punt by the punter Henry, and it's going to roll dead at about the 11, and the Cats will take over from there as we go to the fourth quarter. So three quarters in the books, we go to the fourth. Cats lead by four. We'll be back after this.
Looking for the most effective way to create clean, germ-free spaces where you live, work, and do business? Do you wish you could avoid required wet times, unpleasant odors, and residues left behind by often harsh chemicals? If you're looking for better ways to protect others from harmful infections or lost business and productivity, then call RenewRight today. We're here to provide you with the tools you need to promote safety and peace of mind that those counting on you deserve. If you want disinfection done right, then call RenewRight today at 816-226-7654.
Everyone needs an advocate in the insurance world. Let Lacey Domnick of Shelter Insurance be an advocate for you. With free policy review and quotes, she aims to help you weigh your options. With auto, home, life, and business insurance, Lacey wants you to have a positive and friendly experience. A former Wildcat herself, it is important for Lacey to support the community and Wildcats. Call today to set up an appointment at 816-380-2700 with Lacey.
You know, I noticed something is missing out of those Twizzlers. All the grape. I think Gary eats the grape Twizzlers.
Me?
Yeah, you. So, all right, we go to the fourth quarter. Ball at the 15. And the Cats will take it from the 15 on this drive. And they're going to hand off, fake the handoff. Mitchell keeps it himself. Goes a little bit airborne. Going to get about three. And I like him pulling on the mesh play there, Gary, and keeping it because it's going to keep that defense honest for.
Oh, yeah. I mean, he's making good reads now. I mean, as he gets into the season, more and more he's going to make the better reads. And he's really, even through this game, he's progressed into much better reads. He's pulled the ball several times. I mean, he's got 22 yards on nine carries, but he's had several sacks, so he's got more yards than actually that with rush.
There you go, in motion with Moore. He's going to get set in the backfield. Fake the handoff, going to go to Moore now. Moore cuts back, hurdles the defender. He's on his horse, up past the 25 to about the 30-yard line. Say the 29, 10-yard gain by Mr. Moore.
That's a first down. That is the sixth first down of the half.
So Michael Moore with the first down, and it's a Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center first down. Think Trobe's first. When you think home appliances. I've been trying to get him to do that every time, and he's not figuring it out. So first and 10, ball at their own 29. In motion, they're going to go with Baker. He goes back out to the side, and they're going to go on the counter for Reynolds. And Reynolds stays on his feet, making guys miss, still on his feet. Bouncing off tacklers, gets about four.
22, Nate Reynolds, the ball carrier, brings up second down, short game on the play.
Down on the ground, that might be Fatka. So a Warrensburg Tiger on the field. We'll take a quick timeout. Cats lead with the ball and 10:30 to go in the ball game.
New logo, new colors, new app, and a new online banking platform. There may be a lot of new at Sherwood Community Bank, but one thing remains the same, community. Serving the area with four convenient locations, Sherwood is still your community bank. Come see what it's like to be part of the community with a new account. The small town bank with big city convenience. Sherwood Community Bank, your community bank.
Sherwood Heating and Cooling provides quality services and amazing products from Carrier. Always going the extra mile to ensure that your heating and cooling units keep performing at optimal levels. Sherwood Heating and Cooling wants your family to be as comfortable as their own. Products come with warranties and service checkups by trained technicians that give you peace of mind. Call and schedule an appointment at 816-862-6610.
Welcome back. Second down coming up after Fatka was helped off the field there. In motion, they go with Baker, and he comes back to the outside on the right side. Hand off four more. And he's going to get back to the line of scrimmage. Might have got a half a yard. Going to bring up third down for the Cats. With 10:08 to go here in the fourth. So third down coming up for the Cats here. Big third down here for both sides on this one, Gary. With fourth quarter time ticking.
And who do you think they're going to give it to?
And they got a pretty good idea, but we'll see. So here we go on third down and five. And this time they're going to fake the handoff. No, they're going to give to Moore and nowhere to go.
That was one of those that he tried to pull, and Moore had already clamped down on it.
So it brings up fourth down. And the Cats going to have to punt it away. So with 9:20 to go in the fourth and a punt coming for the Cats. So neither team able to really take a stranglehold on this game. It looks like when momentum goes one way, it shifts right back the other way. Now Warrensburg with a big stop. And on fourth down and four, Cats are to punt it away. You notice they got a couple of spies out there on Reynolds, and he's going to boot it away. Ball inside the 40 to about the 35-yard line. Going to bring up first and 10 for the Tigers. So ball, where are they going to mark it? They're going to mark it at about the 37, I believe. So first and 10 from their own 37. 8:53 to go, fourth quarter. Warrensburg trails by four. Looking to get back on the plus side of things. If they get a touchdown, they would lead by three again. Two wide receivers both ways. In motion with Morris. Fake the handoff, look to throw. And he's going to chuck one deep again, way underneath it. And they're going to call the flag. So 15-yard penalty is going to put them into Cat territory to the 48-yard line. They're definitely calling the pass interference. They're not letting them do any hand fighting or anything here tonight. So that will put them into plus territory on the Cat side of the field. And again, those are ones you'll take. However, you keep chucking them deep and they keep calling it, you just may keep doing it. That's what happened on the drive earlier, two straight.
And they had good coverage. They had double coverage on him at that point in time. I didn't see exactly where the penalty was at, because it was long ways before where the ball ended up being. So
in motion to Morris. Morris is going to get the handoff, cut back to the 45, and a couple of Cats in there. Wyatt Smith and others going to bring up a second down. Second and about six. So second and six coming up. Ball the 44 of the Wildcats. 2 wide receivers far side. Morris linked out near side, usually in motion. This time they're going to go in motion the other way. Double reverse to Morris, and Morris breaks the tackle, gets a first down to the 37. And it brings up a first and 10 to the 37-yard line with 8:03 to go.
The first and 10.
Clock ticks under 8 here in the fourth quarter.
As the play comes in for the Tigers. Dobie Westfall once again takes this throw at the line.
First and 10 coming up for Warrensburg. And this time they've got Mr. Munsterman inside the 20 to the 15-yard line. Ryan Munsterman. That's about the fourth time tonight. Ryan Munsterman. Down to the 15. Big chunky yardage for him.
22 yards.
So good change of pace there by Warrensburg. Gets him a first and 10 inside the 20 to the 15. Ryan's going to stay back there. He's going to get another handoff inside the 10 to about the 9-yard line. They're going to mark him at the 10.
He'll
bring up second down. So 5-yard run by Ryan Munsterman. And they're in business down to the 5-yard line. Wide receiver flanked out. Near side is Kreisel. 2 wide receivers far side. And this time they're going to give it to Munsterman. He's going to go up the middle, get close to another first down. Going to be about a yard shy. Going to bring up third and 1 with 6:40 to go, fourth quarter.
Ryan Munsterman, the ball carrier.
Kind of looks like Munsterman is their, for all practical purposes, calling fullback. I mean, he's just a bruise runner, but my gosh, Morris is as well. So,
and, you know, you got 2 seniors in that backfield. You're going to have some runners in the backfield, mix in a sophomore with them every once in a while. So Hong and Munsterman in the backfield flanking Westfall on third down and nowhere to go. Cats read that one. Fourth down, another tackle by Kale Weber in the backfield. His third tackle for the loss tonight. He's had an excellent game, brings up fourth down.
And replay on your screen.
So good read there. So fourth and 6, and Warrensburg going to call a timeout, talking over. Big play coming up when we come back. 5:50 to go fourth. Cats up by 4. Warrensburg trying to get on the board.
New logo, new colors, new app, and a new online banking platform. There may be a lot of new at Sherwood Community Bank, but one thing remains the same: community. Serving the area with 4 convenient locations, Sherwood is still your community bank. Come see what it's like to be part of the community with a new account. The small town bank with big city convenience. Sherwood Community Bank, your community bank.
Sherwood Heating and Cooling provides quality services and amazing products from Carrier. Always going the extra mile to ensure that your heating and cooling units keep performing at optimal levels. Sherwood Heating and Cooling wants your family to be as comfortable as their own. Products come with warranties and service checkups by trained technicians that give you peace of mind. Call and schedule an appointment at 816-862-6610.
All right, here we go with a big fourth down coming up. Shotgun formation. Westfall's got Munsterman with him. The backfield is going to go in motion with Morris. And they're going to fake the handoff. They're going to throw it over the top. Touchdown, Warrensburg. So Kreisel was wide open on the touchdown. See the replay here on the go-ahead touchdown. That's the one guy you probably want to guard. And they did not. And it is a touchdown. 23-21. Tigers extra point coming up. 5:47 to go here. fourth quarter in a back-and-forth battle. Kick is up. Kick is good. Cats got some work to do down three. 5:47 to go. We'll be back.
You have choices when buying a vehicle. Show Me Auto Mall is your right choice. Getting you financed with even less than perfect credit, because everyone needs a reliable vehicle at an affordable price. Need service? Take a loaner while you wait. With a broad selection, you will find a vehicle that is right for you. Show Me Auto Mall is here to make buying a vehicle hassle-free. Go see the crew at Show Me today on 291 across from Walmart.
Everyone needs a little kickstart at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so head to Sonic of Harrisonville and kick away the afternoon fog. Grab an ice-cold drink full of caffeine and kickstart your afternoon and evening. The best part, 2 to 4 is happy hour, and drinks are half price. Grab an afternoon snack of Cheesy Bites or Jalapeno Poppers, or order on the app for happy hour anytime. Sonic Happy Hour, where you kick away the fog. Also, visit 4tees.com and sign up for the Sonic Kick Return Contest.
Welcome back. We'll give the scoring summary on that drive. It was 63 yards, 3 minutes and 15 seconds, total of 7 plays. Ended up with the 11-yard touchdown reception by Kreisel, making the score. Your Cats 21, Warrensburg Tigers 24.
So Henry set to kick it deep. Looks like Injun Lawful back there. High end over end kick, taken by the Cats at their own 4. Looking for a seam to the 10, 15, cut back to the 18. Cats will have a long field with 5:40 to go here in the ball game. I say in the ball game, but the Cats do have a kicker too. And we talked about it early in the game. You said, you know what? Might be a situation you got to have a kick later in the game. And here we are. Cats need 3 to tie. They need a 7 to put the pressure on the Tigers.
They need a 5-minute and 40-minute drive to end in a touchdown. That way it doesn't give the Warrensburg any time left on the clock. They've got 3 timeouts left, too, to work with. So
here we go, 1st and 10 for the Cats. In motion, they're going to go with Baker. Reynolds in the backfield, they're going to throw it out in the flat. They got it to Moore. And Moore is going to be out of bounds on the far side after a gain of about 8. And that'll bring up a 2nd down. I like that. Come out throwing a little bubble screen to your running back.
So you're going to give him 10 yards.
So you got 10 and a 1st down. That's a Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center 1st down. Think Trobe's first when you think home appliances. Split backs in the backfield. Under center is Mitchell. Wide receiver in motion is Baker. From right to left, going to wrap around. And now handoff for Reynolds. And Reynolds still on his feet. Ryan Munsterman wraps him up after a gain of about 3 for Reynolds. New set of receivers check in for the Cats. We have Cockmeyer and not sure who checked in with him. Maybe that was Drogi. 3 wide receivers near side, 1 to the far side. Reynolds with Mitchell in the backfield on 2nd and 7. Mitchell looking to pass. He's got his man sideline out of bounds at the 45. Toe tap on the near side by Eli Baker. He's become a force, Gary. With those receptions, he had a little toe tap on the near side and out of bounds. 1st and 10. So the Cats move the chains up to the 43 with 4:49 to go. Almost moving too fast for us, Gary. So here we go on 1st and 10 from their own 44. Gonna go in motion with Reynolds, and up the middle they go with Moore. And Moore stays on his feet, past midfield to the 49. And again, Munsterman in on that. Ryan Munsterman has had a solid night, Gary. And I may be a little partial. He is my cousin, but
well, you know, Munsterman for the Tigers and Kel Weber for the Wildcats on defense. And I tell you what, we're getting positive yards, 422 and counting on the clock for the fourth quarter.
In motion, they're going to go with Baker. Wraps around the running backs. Handoff for Reynolds. Nope. Mitchell keeps it himself.
That was a good pull. First down, gain of four.
Down to the 45 of the Tigers with 4:08 to go in the fourth.
It's the third first down on this drive.
First and 10 down to the 45.
They've equaled the total in first downs that they had in the first half. They've got 18 for the game.
So first and 10 down to the 45. Two wide receivers set far side. In motion they go with Baker. Lone back is Moore. And Michael Moore, they're going to throw it out in the flats for Reynolds. Reynolds to the 40, to the 35, 30, strips a tackle inside the 30 to the 27-yard line. Tossed out of bounds on the far side. But another first down. Watch this replay coming up. And again, I think they give him a run. Gary marked that down as a screen pass. I'm not sure if they go screen or run on those when they're behind the line of scrimmage like that, but nevertheless, it was a big chunk of yardage.
Yeah, it was. I mean, he's getting total yards, that's all. I mean, he's 89 yards in receptions, four receptions, and he's 86 yards on rushing, or a total of 190 yards total for the game.
Three wide receivers are going to go in motion with Moore this time. He's going to set in the back, and they're going to call that penalty. I saw that one. Moore was headed towards the line of scrimmage instead of straight across.
And that's the fourth one like that.
And those have all come from the far side.
Well, I am sure they're getting discussion from the coaching staff
and,
over
and
there.
And that's probably something that Coach Kavanaugh saw on film, and he's like, I'm going to make and point that out to him, is they're cutting towards the you it's an illegal play. You can't
do
that. And so you're going to have to get back into your, you know, practice and say, guys, you got to go parallel with the line. You cannot turn your shoulders. And turning your shoulders is definitely going to do it. So 3:22 to go, first and 15 for the Cats from their own 33. Split backs in the backfield. And they go counter for Reynolds.
Ball.
And Reynolds kind of dribbled that one. Brings up second and 16 on a one-yard loss. So he's going to lose a yard on that one. Brings up second down and 16.
Well, I would venture to say we're in four-play territory here, four-down territory. But you got to get some positive yards here because you don't want a long, long third-down play.
Clock is not the friend of the Cats right now. 2:40 to go here in the fourth. Second and 16. They fake the handoff.
Looks open.
Throw. He had a couple of guys. Now
run the ball.
It. Down to the
good block.
Out of bounds at about the 18. Going to be real close to a first down. Going to be about a half yard short.
That was an excellent block by Moore downfield when he saw his quarterback what he was going to do.
And that might have been a rollout by design run right there, even though he looked to pass.
14 yards on the carry.
So just about a yard short, but the clock stops as he goes out of bounds inside the 20 to the 18. Third down in the yard. Near side wide receiver is Baker. Split backs in the backfield. Reynolds and Moore. They're going to go in motion by Baker, and they're going to hand off for Reynolds. He's got the first down. Stays on his feet. Whistle blows.
Did you see him jump up towards the line a little bit closer so he'd hit the hole faster?
Yes. That was the first thing I noticed. But it is enough for Trobe's Maytag Home Appliance Center. First down. Think Trobe's first. When you think home appliances.
Fifth first down on this drive alone. 11th for the second half. And the 20th of the game. So that's ball control.
So 2:10 to go and running here. Two wide receivers near side, including Reynolds. Shotgun formation. They're going to go in motion with Reynolds. And
holes there.
Off four more inside the 10. He's going to have close to another first down.
25, Michael Moore, digging his way
Ball to the 7-yard line. Now, if you're Warrensburg, you start thinking about taking a couple of those timeouts you got, because the Cats are in business inside the 10, down to about the 8-yard line. They're going to mark it at the 7. It's a second and short,
which gives them a first down and then first and goal, probably less than 5 yards to go.
24-21, Cats down by 3, driving on the Tigers here. Motion, they're going to hand off Reynolds. He hits it inside the 5, down to about the 4 with 1:11 to go. Whistle and a timeout called. See what they're going to call. Warrensburg going to call a timeout now on first and goal from the 4.
And we said this at the very beginning of the game. First of all, they've got people going both ways. They've also, Harrisonville has had the ball 14, 19, 22, and now 26 minutes of this game.
Yeah, and that we talked about it. You know, we got all kinds of things going on, and James was just saying something in my ear, and I wasn't quite sure what he said there, but I like the fact that I can hear my producer in my ear. So we got about 1:11 to go here. So 24-21, let's reset things for you. Warrensburg has one timeout left. The Cats have 3 with a minute and 11 to go here in the fourth quarter. A touchdown gives you the lead, but you are in field goal territory and you're in the middle of the field for a fresh field goal kicker, one of those straight on. If you have to go that route, you don't want to take a big sack here. If you're the Wildcats, you want to hold on to the football and try to get in the end zone.
You know, those interior linemen are tired. They play both ways of Warrensburg. I'm saying hit it, hit it, hit it with Moore and Reynolds and get a touchdown right here.
Split backs in the backfield. Mitchell talking to Moore and Reynolds.
This drive started on the 17 of Harrisonville.
And they're going to hand off for Moore.
He's in.
5. Touchdown, Cats! Michael Moore, 4-6. And the Cats lead 27-24. Extra point coming up. And I want to tell you right now, Gary, Nate Reynolds has something Jace didn't have most of his high school career. A complimentary back. Michael Moore has had a great game tonight, and he gets into the end zone when the Cats need it. There's a whistle and a flag. They're going to call offsides. You still kick the extra point.
Oh, absolutely. 12 play, 83-yard drive. Started on Harrisonville 17. Took up 4 minutes and 45 seconds, culminated by that 4-yard touchdown run by Michael Moore. Extra point coming up.
And that scoring summary brought to you by Lacey Dominic of Shelter Insurance. You need a summary of your insurance, give her a call today. Kick is up. Kick is good. Cats lead by 4. 1:07 to go here in this one. Cats going to try to close it out when we come back.
Insurance is something we all have to have. Go somewhere with all insurances in one place. Stafford and Stafford Insurance. With auto, commercial, life, health, farm, and crop insurance, Stafford has you covered. With coverage like that, they are sure to have the right policy for you. Instead of dreading a call to get an insurance quote, call the team that covers it all. Stafford and Stafford Insurance, located on Commercial across from Holland's Auto Sales.
It always seems to happen. We buy new tires and a week later we run over a nail. Not a problem when you have purchased your tires at Young's Tire and Wheel Center. You get free flat repair for the life of your tires. On a budget, Young's has the best selection of new and used tires to save a little extra money. When the time comes for new tires, stop at the shop 4T's Trust to keep them rolling down the highway. Young's Tire and Wheel Center on South Commercial in Harrisonville.
All right, welcome back. 1:07 to go. Nothing solved in this one. Warrensburg does need a touchdown, though, as they're down by 4 here. Cats looking for their first win of the year. After three brutal contests, they have another dog fight on their hands tonight. I should say cat fight, as they're playing the Tigers. Probably not a dog fight, but nevertheless, it's been a good back and forth battle. Two old conference foes from the West Central Conference days and now in the MRVC West. Cockmeyer's set to kick it deep. High end over end kick going to be taken by Morris at the 15. He can break one at any time. And up the middle he goes to the 30 to the 35-yard line. Gary, 101 to go here in the ballgame. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to bracket Kreisel. I'm going to have somebody deep on him, and I'm also going to have a spy on him. I'm going to have somebody, a spy out of the backfield, because Morris can run it out of the backfield as well. I'm assuming we're going to see Munsterman in there as well as you see him in the backfield. So,
but they've only got one timeout. Clock stops on first downs, so they really don't have a whole lot of time. They're going to be passing, I think, most of the time. So I'm playing defense just like there are. They've got six, five guys that are 14 yards deep.
So here we go, shotgun formation. And now pressure getting to,
got him,
getting to Westfall, and they bring him down. The sack by the Cats. Cale Weber, have a game, buddy. He has been in the backfield all night long, and he does it again right here.
Replay on the screen.
His first sack of the night, but his third tackle for loss.
And more importantly, that took their last timeout because they had to call a timeout now because that's all of their timeouts. They're out of timeouts. The clock will only stop when they get a first down.
Nope.
I've already got my player of the game. I'm sorry. I know there's a lot on offense, but
so hey, sometimes we're all on the same page. Sometimes we all look at each other and we're like, "What is going on?" So we have 52.3 seconds to go. That Warrensburg timeout was their last. They're down by four. They're at their own 35-yard line. They got 65 yards to go after that sack on first down. And again, the Cats going to go with that prevent type style defense. Two wide receivers to your left, two to your right. I'm going to throw a little one in the flats if I would be Warrensburg. Looking Westfall, looking. And he's got his man on the far side. And they're going to say he got out of bounds up to the 44-yard line. That was Kreisel again.
That's unofficially 102 yards for Kreisel.
Solid game for Kreisel, the junior wide receiver. So third down, though, coming up. Third and a pair. Two wide receivers to your left, two to your right. Shotgun formation for Westfall. And here they go. They're going to throw a little quick out to Kreisel, and Kreisel's on his feet, looking to go. Spins out of a tackle, still on his feet. First down inside the 45 to the 44-yard line. So first down, they're going to have to hurry. They get up there quickly, 35 seconds to go. That one wasted a lot of time. And then a clock killer there by Westfall. Going to bring up second down and 10. From about the 44-yard line. I like that play call, play design, get him in space, and he made something happen there on that third down play. So 32 seconds to go here, fourth quarter. Probably the biggest crowd we've had on the visitor sideline yet this year.
Oh, yeah.
It's since we put those in. We're going to go in motion with it. Morris going to come over to the near side. 20 seconds on the play clock. And there's a flag. I knew that
too
was
many people,
coming.
Too many people in the backfield.
And he's going to look to throw it deep, and it's not going to matter even if he caught it. It was incomplete, and it was. There was nobody covering up the tackle on
right.
The near side. I saw that.
And now they're going to get 15 for unsportsmanlike on the other side because they thought they caught it. The thing about it is it didn't make any difference. They didn't see this flag over here.
Or did they call that or a sideline warning? I wonder if they got a sideline warning on that.
They could have.
So 23.4 to go, 4-point Cat lead. They're going to discuss this one. And if that's a dead ball, it's 5 yards and a 15, if it is a 15-yard unsportsmanlike. So this is going to push them way back. They're going to discuss it here.
Here comes the calls.
So a false start or procedure. They were not lined up. They didn't have the tackle covered on the near side.
second call.
Unsportsman, 15. And that's going to be after the play.
So that was a smart move by Harrisonville because it takes the down and it pushes them back on their own side of the field. I'm not sure what happened. I didn't see over there on
well,
what
they
happened.
Thought they were thinking he caught it, but what they didn't realize, it didn't make any difference whether he caught it or not because it was not going to be a play.
Yeah. So third down and just outside
of Clinton.
Yes. Here they go. Third down and long. He's going to chuck one deep. He threw it as far as he can and overthrows his target by about 2 yards. And that brings up fourth down and 26. So fourth and long coming up.
He had a pretty good gun there, too.
That was a nice nice arm, nice ball, just a little bit too far. Now if you're the catch, you don't get any penalties, and you just make him knock it down. Throw it up in the air. No, incomplete. Hit.
Wow.
What a hit by the Cats.
Let's get the – I want to see who
I
hit that.
I think that was Espen Glenn on the hit. And that ball's going to die there. See if we can get a – yeah, we're going to see a replay here. Watch this. And that was Espen Glenn. Game-saving stop by the Cats. And they're going to get their first win of the season with 7.8 seconds to go. 28-24, Cats with the lead. All they need is one kneel down to send this one in the books. I talked to countless people from Warrensburg, from Harrisonville, and we said the whole time this one was going to be a toss-up, and it lived up to the billing. There's a kneel down. Cats knock off the Berg, 28-24. We're going to take a timeout, and we'll be back with your post-game show. After this, we'll wrap it up. We'll have a Warrensburg play of the game. We'll have all kinds of fun stuff on your post-game show. Watch for those replays. We'll be back after this.
What is one of your most precious commodities? Time. With sports, family, work, and school, time is precious. So why drive hours and waste time to save $20? Shop local and buy your home appliances at Troby's Maytag Home Appliance Center right here in Harrisonville. They deliver, service, issues that arise, all while you're putting money right back into the community. Stop wasting time and think Troby's first when you think of home appliances on Plaza Drive right behind Hawthorne Bank.
Ready to upgrade your patio for those football watch parties? Call Ethan Young with 2-3 Construction Services to get started today. He can create a fun patio area complete with a fire pit in case it gets a bit chilly for one of those Wildcat or Chiefs fall nights. If a new driveway or floor for the shop is part of your upgrade, he will help you there as well. Call Ethan today at 816-533-2119 and 2-3 Construction Services to work for you.
That works. That first one was bright. Oh, welcome back. Sorry about that. We were getting set up here in the post-game show. Cats win it 28-24. A back-and-forth battle in this one. And the Cats are able to come away victorious. I said it at the end of the game. I said it in the pregame show. I felt like this was one of those toss-up games either way, and it lived up to that billing tonight as it really was a toss-up game, Gary. As Gary, you see him feverishly adding up stats and stuff, and we'll get his stats, and then we'll get into some of the highlights from tonight. As both teams, you know, they threw haymakers at one another here tonight. Countless times we thought, okay, one of these teams is going to take over. One of these teams is going to take over and do something well, and just they did not nobody really took control of the game. I felt like late in the game, that long drive really set the tone for the Wildcats. But other than that, you know, both teams played into each other's kind of what they wanted to do here tonight. Gary, you got some stats. I'll let you go over those stats.
For your Harrisonville Wildcats, 430 total yards by the Cats. 191 of those were rushing. 239 of those were passing. Now, some of those that may have been laterals, I'm not sure exactly how, but still a total of 430 yards, capped off by 90 yards rushing by Reynolds and 89 yards pass receptions by Reynolds. So you're looking at almost 180 yards total by Reynolds alone out of that 430. Also, and he had 20 rush attempts and 4 receptions. Also, Michael Moore had a total of 15 carries for 61 yards, and Mitchell had 11 carries for 40 yards. Also, you can't forget about Drogi. Drogi had that 77-yard touchdown reception there in the first quarter. And also, Moore had a total of 41 yards receiving. I'll go over the scoring for the Cats in just a minute. For Warrensburg, they had a total of 292 yards unofficially, 155 yards rushing, and 137 yards passing. Of that 137 yards, 113 of that was Kreisel. Kreisel was lights out tonight. He had 9 receptions for 113 yards. Harrisonville controlled the clock tonight. I think that was the thing. With the 430 yards that they had the clock. They had 27 minutes and 15 seconds, where Warrensburg only had 20:45. And we talked about that. You know, they've got people going both ways. Harrisonville platoons. So, I'm going to go ahead and preempt your player of the game a little bit to a certain extent. The reason is because Reynolds. I think I'm going to vote for two. The offensive side, Reynolds did everything he needed to do for his team tonight to score and get points and get first downs when he needed them. On the defensive side, Kel Weber did everything he possibly could to help his defense. And you said it. I think he had 3 or 4 tackles for a loss, one of them in that last drive, which made a huge difference. I'm excited. that was a tremendous game.
This guy likes participation trophies. He's trying to give everybody player of the game. I don't know.
Well, who are you going to vote for then?
I'm going Kel Weber. We talked about it. The defense has struggled this year at times. Kel Weber did what he had to do tonight. He had those 3 tackles for losses, one being a sack that forced Warrensburg late in the game to call their last timeout. That was the big difference on that last drive, the sack and then the timeout, Gary. And I think he deserves it, and I think the defense deserves some praise. They got the stop when they needed it.
Oh, absolutely. The defense started out kind of a little bit flat. I mean, the first touchdown that Warrensburg, they had a 7 play drive over 55 yards, but then they had the 1 play touchdown right after that, which ended up ultimately the score was tied 14-14 after Harrisonville scored their quick touchdown. But I tell you, I think it was a complete game tonight. Special teams did what they needed to do, but the offense did what that 430 yards total offense. I mean, you can't ask for any more than that. And then the defense, when it mattered, they stepped up and they started playing defense, and they were able to hold a good Warrensburg offense to only 292 yards.
And I think also we talked about it, Gary. Those linemen playing both ways, they were worn down late in that game. A lot of hits and a lot of punishment from Moore and Reynolds really wore the interior of that line down, and it showed in the second half. Those 2 and 3 yard runs became 6 and 7 yard runs and maybe even more. And I really think that's something that played into the final score of this game as well.
I agree. And talking about Warrensburg, their quarterback did an excellent job. I mean, Westfall is just a sophomore. I mean, and he, up until a point in the game, until I jinxed him for some reason, he hadn't missed a throw. He had bullets when he needed to. He put air under when he needed to. And so he played an excellent game. But Kreisel was his go-to guy. And 113 yards reception, that is exceptional for a high school game. I mean, I think he did an excellent job talking about Warrensburg. I mean, they brought in a quality product here tonight.
Absolutely. And we're going to start watching some replays as we finish talking about this, Gary. We're start with the Wildcats here. And just see kind of how they work the inside of that field throughout the game. They were able to get some good passes off as well, and that's one of those things that I really enjoyed watching from the Cats tonight. But here's the big thing, Gary, as you see a couple of these passes and close to a touchdown here, and we'll get into it a little bit more, but look at a lot of the names we called tonight for both sides. Sophomore, sophomore, junior, sophomore, maybe a senior here and there on a couple of the Warrensburg guys. But overall, this is going to be a heck of a series the next 2 to 3 years.
That it is. I mean, you're talking about youth on this that's getting varsity experience, you know, and they're going to be forced to be reckoned with whenever it comes in the next couple of years.
And here's the series right here. Our Warrensburg plays of the game brought to you by B&B Glass and Power Washing and P31 Salon and Spa from Warrensburg. And right here, you just talk about, look at the ball, Westfall, there on the touchdown to them.
Here's a 77-yard touchdown reception by Drogi. And that came in the first quarter with 2:18 left in the first.
So, you know, back and forth battle. It was what we thought it was going to be. And you see this big plays. Here we go before the end of the first quarter. This is where we went on that spree of runs back and forth that the two teams did battle. I do want to thank B&B Glass and Power Washing and P31 Salon and Spa from Warrensburg for stepping up to sponsor the Warrensburg Tigers here tonight, as they did a great job. They sponsored us in the pregame and in the postgame show. So, again, a shout-out to them. If you're watching from Warrensburg, give them a call. Tucker, Kyler Tucker does a great job. Elizabeth Tucker at P31. And then, of course, Kyler with B&B Glass.
That is that Reynolds pass reception and stuff. You know, earlier you saw the sack. But that was a good – and here's Mitchell backing up and getting out and then being able to get some yardage that he needed to get. But that sack, Mitchell made the right call on that. Unfortunately, he didn't have anybody to throw to, and he didn't make a mistake. Took a sack, came back later to be able to go. And here's Mitchell making a good choice to go ahead and run, not trying to force it into coverage.
Didn't end up scoring there, but he set the stage for later in the game when they needed that big run. I think it was by design, Gary, where he rolled out like he was going to pass. I think he was going to run that one the whole time.
Yeah, and there's a bullet. There's a bullet by Westfall when he needed it. Kreisel, again, we've called his name, and there was a face mask at the end of that run.
So I just like being able to run through all these. Again, that drive stalls out, and here comes the Cats back the other way. Just been back and forth. This shows you we keep going back and forth between the two teams, looking through all these replays, and that's the type of game it was. You know, things about firing one deep, and now he's just going to go get a toe tap from Eli Baker on the near side.
And Baker played, I mean, he's playing, he looks like a college player tiptoeing on the sidelines at several plays.
And that's the thing, we talked about it in the pregame show. You don't win trophies in September, you win them in November. So, in the grand scheme of things, now you're 1-1 in conference. You're 1-3 on the year. You've got a non-conference, your last non-conference matchup of the game you can work on a little bit of stuff with. Summit Christian coming here next Friday night. Then you got Center. That's going to be a load.
Oh, yeah.
And then you have Clinton, Oak Grove, Odessa to finish out your regular season. It can go one of two ways, and I think the Cats are moving in the right direction. Here's a great play.
This
right
was
here.
A great play because they needed this play. And again, you know, you see the athletic ability to get them out of and get a first down there by Reynolds.
And give Ryan Munsterman a great bit of credit there. He stuck right with them. Nate stripped a lot of guys off of him tonight, and Reynolds couldn't get him stripped off that time.
No.
Because if Ryan doesn't make that tackle, that game is over.
Again, Reynolds coming in, hitting the pile, and then actually being able to roll out.
You got a couple more coming up your way here. We're late third quarter of our replays, and we'll get into the game-winning drive here in just a few minutes. Cats are down here.
Excellent play by Mitchell, which got them a first down. And I believe this is the touchdown run,
yeah,
where he had missed four missed tackles to be able to get in the touchdown, into the uh, into the end zone.
So, you know, that's one of those situations, Gary, where you look at that one, that shows you who Nate Reynolds can be as a football player. I mean, he made you miss, and he got the touchdown, and that's what they needed. Now we're into the fourth quarter here, and this is where they go to work. Ryan Munsterman, big gain, change of play back there, and then they get in here, big, I believe this is the big
11-yard touchdown pass here in just a second. Here's one of Kel Weber's tackles for loss. And then here's going to be the touchdown pass to Kreisel to put them up 24-21. Put a little bit of air under it, and that was great. Now here we're in the fourth quarter, and here is our drive. It started. This drive started with 5 minutes and 45 seconds left on the clock, and we were able to take it down all the way to about 1 minute. And another one of those toe touches by Baker. And just able to move the ball as we go. Here's one of those other hard runs by Moore. And you're right. You know, Moore compliments Reynolds in that backfield.
And we talked about that. They haven't had that type of 1-2 punch in the past. I mean, last year they had it a little bit with Jace and Nate, but I don't feel like Jace was at full speed last year. Got hurt about midway through the season. So they've finally got that 1-2 punch, and Moore's becoming more and more confident in himself. He gets us inside the 10 here. And this is going to be the ball game right here on this touchdown run. And he was not going to be denied on this run.
He was not. He wanted this touchdown, and he made sure. There's 1, 2, 3 guys take him into the end zone, you know. And if you saw number 72, he played both ways and gave his heart out for this game.
Play the game right here. Kale Weber, sack, got to call your last time out. That was the play of the game,
I totally
in my
agree.
Opinion. So, you know, it comes down to the end of it. You can go with any of those touchdowns, but Kale Weber doesn't make that sack, and then they get the turnover, they get the long. So a lot of stuff happened tonight, but Cats come up with their first W, Gary, and we got Braxton Grammer up here with us. I don't know that Braxton really knows what to think right now as he spent many years here in Harrisonville, so I'm sure he's a little conflicted on his feelings tonight. I'm sure he wanted his Warrensburg Tigers to win, but at the end of the day,
yeah, but he got a win tonight. I mean, yeah, he may not have been from Harrisonville tonight, but he spent most of his life here in Harrisonville. So it was 50-50 for him. Either way he went, he was going to come out a winner, and he did come out a winner, didn't you? There we go.
So,
okay.
Final score again tonight, 28-24, and that's pretty much going to wrap it up for us tonight. I, of course, want to thank all my great producers back here. You have Jerry Forschler. You have Tucker Forschler. You have James Hinkle all in the background. We have you up here with me. I mean, we always have a great setup. We've got a TV in front of us that we can look at. We got a camera that we're supposed to look at that James gives us a hard time because we don't always look into the camera. But nevertheless, it was another great broadcast, and we were glad to bring it to you. For Jerry Forschler, for Tucker Forschler, for James Hinkle, for Gary Davidson, and Braxton Grammer, I'm Chad Grammer saying, good night from Harrisonville. We'll see you back here next Friday night.